We now return to Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan, edited for GOATS.
Marooned for all eternity in the center of a dead planet. Buried alive. Buried alive.
Lois, I need $28,000.
For what?
I've decided I want to open a sushi restaurant.
What do you know about sushi?
I don't care about the sushi. I just want to yell at customers when they walk in the door. Irashaimase! Hajime mashite! Here comes a black guy!
Peter, you're not getting money for that or anything else. We're running seriously low on cash right now. In fact, I may have to get my own full-time job.
Geez, are we really living that close to the edge?
You know we are, Brian. Why do you think we waited so long to take you to the groomers last month?
Hey, isn't it time for me to get a haircut?
Oh, no. I think you just got one.
Are you sure? Because I feel like my nails are really long.
Yeah, I'll check, but I'm pretty sure it's not for another couple of weeks.
What day is this?
Like it or not, we're going to have to start living on a strict budget for a while.
Good evening, I'm Tom Tucker, and this is News... I thought you were going to sing with me, Joyce. Okay. Our top story tonight, the Rhode Island State Lottery has climbed to a record $150 million jackpot.
That's right, Tom. Powerball fever has officially gripped Quahog.
We sent Channel 5 News Asian correspondent Trisha Takanawa around town to get the public reaction.
Mayor West, what do you plan to do if you win the lottery?
Well, I'd finally splurge and buy myself one of those fancy four-piece suits.
I'd like to join your country club. I assume that won't be a problem.
And how about you, every Persian guy in the world?
White BMW!
Well, there you go, Lois. That's the answer right there. We'll just win the lottery. In fact, I'm gonna go buy my winning ticket right now.
Peter, what's wrong?
It's, nothing. I'm just gonna wait a minute. There's teenagers in skinny jeans out there. Everyone, I got big news. We are gonna be rich.
Oh my God, Peter, there are thousands of lottery tickets here. Where did you get the money for all these?
Simple. I took out a second mortgage on a house.
What?
Peter, this is idiotic. Your odds of winning are like 100 million to 1. Don't you know the lottery is just a tax on stupid people?
Would you be saying that if the prize was 150 million bags at a neighbor's garbage?
But it's not. I mean, is it? That is an unrealistic, unfair question.
Peter, Brian's right. How can you be so irresponsible? You take these tickets back right now.
No way, Lois. We're gonna win. I got lots of good karma built up from doing those USO shows. So, apparently, they found a weapon of mass destruction. My putter. All right, boys, go get him over there. And now, please welcome Mr. Bruce Jenner. I just wanted to remind you fellas what you're all fighting for. Okay, this is it, you guys. They're gonna announce the winning lottery numbers. Time for the Griffin family to meet its destiny.
When we lose, I'm getting a divorce.
Understood.
We're here live in our studio where a checkout girl in a cheap dress who wants to be a model is ready to draw the winning numbers.
E!
That's a 3, honey. Turn it around.
This!
31.
Spooky ghost mouth!
That's a 0.
Snowman!
8.
2 sailboats!
44.
17!
No, that's... Oh, yes, that is 17. She's good at 17. Well, folks, those are our winning numbers. Good luck to all of
us. 24!
No, that's it. We're done. Anyone watching, do not count 24.
Pancakes!
Okay, I don't know what she's doing now. Somebody turn the machine off. Nikki, that's good. That's good. Go wait in my car. All right, you did good. Gonna take her to Walt's Roast Beef.
All right, kids, we got 200,000 lottery tickets we gotta check. All right, how do you want to do this? A static shot of the house where night turns into day, or a montage song that over-explains what we're doing?
That second one sounds like it could be funny.
Checking lottery tickets, looking at the numbers, and seeing if they match the ones on the news. If they do, then we're winners. If they don't, then we put them in the designated pile for tickets we already checked. This is taking forever. That's why Brian is yawning and Stewie's rubbing his eyes. The montage is almost over. That's why the music and the vocals are fading out right now.
Well, that's it. 3 days wasted looking through 200,000 lottery tickets.
Those weren't the lottery tickets. That was a test. These are the lottery tickets.
Is this another test?
Yes. These aren't the real lottery tickets either. These are the real lottery tickets.
So in addition to buying 200,000 lottery tickets, you had 400,000 fake ones printed up?
I had to be sure.
Oh my God! We won!
What?
Let me see that. Yes, we won the lottery! I'm getting a penis, butler.
Sir?
All right, buttle my penis. Buttle it! This is awesome. Now that we're rich, our lives are going to be so much better.
You sure it was such a good idea to cash that lottery check? It seems foolish to have all this money lying around.
Oh, you'd rather have it down at the bank where the Jewish guys can leer at it?
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah, money!
Woo!
Hello?
Did you blow all your money yet?
No, Daddy.
All right, call me when you blow all your money. Love you, bye.
All right, so how are we going to spend our winnings?
I'm going to get some supermarket fried chicken and eat it until I'm nauseous.
I'm going to finally get my gal that doodad she's been wanting.
I'm going to get a floor mirror to squat over and see what's making all that noise.
Okay, everybody just calm down. We're not going to go crazy spending our winnings, and we're not going to let this money change us.
What are you talking about? This money is our ticket to the good life, starting now. I just bought a giant room full of gold coins, and I'm going to dive into it like Scrooge McDuck. It's not a liquid! It's a great many pieces of solid matter that form a hard floor-like surface! Ah!
Peter, what are you doing here? Shouldn't you be at work?
I quit my job, Lois.
You what?
Yeah, we're rich now. I don't need to be working. Oh, you should have been there, Lois. I told Angela what she could do with that job just like I always fantasized. Angela, I just want to thank you for several extremely pleasurable years working for this corporation. Certain unexpected developments have created a situation where I am no longer in need of employment. I would be remiss, however, if I did not extend my gratitude to you for your unwavering fairness and belief in me, and there is a giant poo on your desk. Hey, Horace, another round for everybody!
Yeah! Gosh, Peter, you're really being generous with your money.
Hey, what's the point of being rich if you can't share it with your pals, huh?
Okay, wait, I got one. Who would you rather do? Susan Boyle, or a sex doll that's been passed around a fraternity?
Well, have they been cleaning the doll?
Please, these guys are betas. They're total animals.
Hey, I got one, Peter. What would you rather do? Tread water where you are right now, or increase your net worth fivefold within the next 18 months?
Huh? What are you talking about?
Well, my friend Marty is a whiz with chemistry, and he says he's come up with a new penis enlargement pill, and if we can bankroll him $100,000 in startup money, he'll triple our investment in a year.
Well, gee, I don't,
Peter, I've taken the liberty of mocking up some sales projections.
Wow, that's pretty good.
And this would be our net profits.
Yikes.
You know, Peter, Bonnie's birthday is coming up, and I'll be gall darned if I didn't go ahead and promise her that Stevie Nicks would come to our house and sing three songs to her. Boy, do I got a big mouth, huh?
Hey, yeah, if you're gonna open your mouth with the missus, stick to kisses, eh?
What neat humor! What neat humor!
Yeah, so what do you say, Peter? Can you help us out?
Of course I can, you dope. We're pals, right? There you go. Hey, Horace, give us three shots of your best bourbon. And have that Russian waiter I like bring it over.
La 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 la. Oh. La 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 la. Ho 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 ho!
Ho 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 ho!
La 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 la
la la la la
la la la la la la
la la la la la la la la la la
la la la la la la la la la la.
Boy, you wouldn't guess from that smile that all his kids were stillborn, huh?
All right, well. Thanks again, Peter. I gotta head out. I told my mother I'd visit her in the hospital.
Yeah, and I gotta work. I'm flying a leg to Minneapolis tonight.
Oh. Yeah, I understand. You got other things to do. I just wrote you guys a couple of checks. But no, you do your things.
What?
No, I mean, I'm just saying. I thought friends hang out, do things with each other. You know, especially when one friend gives the other friends a whole bunch of money.
Oh, well, I guess I could stick around.
Yeah, and I guess the co-pilot can fly the plane. She's a woman, and passengers are usually okay with that.
I once saw a deodorant commercial that had a woman pilot.
That's more like it. From now on, we're all gonna do whatever I wanna do. Cause I'm the one with the dough.
Okay, I guess that's fair.
Good. Cause what I wanna do is stay here, get drunk, and watch TV.
We now return to Michael McDonald during allergy season.
Hey, Peter, you wanted me to watch the entire first season of True Blood and come show you where there was boob?
That's right. I don't want to see any actual True Blood. Just boob.
Yeah, well, I found some.
No! Anna Paquin boob does not count as real boob. That's like looking at a 12-year-old boy. Jeez, you should know that, Joe. You should definitely know that.
Sorry, Peter.
Sorry doesn't show me nipples worth seeing. And as for you, Anna, you're dreadful and so is the program.
I didn't write it.
Yeah, but you know the people who do. That Alan Ball, you know him, right?
Yeah?
How come everything he writes is so dreary?
I don't know.
Tell him to cheer up. Things ain't so bad.
This is a weird episode.
Okay, Quagmire, I want you to take the first bite out of this fudge pop, because that first bite is the one that really hurts.
Well, okay.
Ow! Ow! Yeah, that's right, Ow. Now you swallow that. Don't you dare spit that out.
What's the difference? You got what you wanted?
I said swallow it! Now smear what's left of it on your face and look at me with your mouth open. Look at yourself, you filthy whore. I don't even want this now. Okay, guys, now you're gonna do a synchronized duet of making whoopee while I shoot you with this BB gun.
That doesn't sound safe.
Action!
Another ride.
You look so gay.
Another June.
Oh, what a day.
Another sunny honeymoon.
Hip, hip, hurrah.
Another season. Another reason
for making whoopee.
Look, you aren't gonna shoot us in the eye, are you, Peter?
Oh, no, Joe. I wouldn't try to shoot you in the eye.
A lot of shoes.
We're throwing shoes.
A lot of rice.
It's also nice. Ah! Peter, it was really close to my eye.
Relax, Joe. I'm nowhere near your eye. Hey, Joe, open your eye.
Stop!
Gotcha!
What the hell, Peter? You shot him in the eye!
Keep singing, you! And keep your chin up so I can see your throat!
No, no, screw this! You're a jerk!
Jerk? What kind of a way is that to talk to your friend who gives you money?
Go to hell, Peter! We don't need your money! And we don't need friends like you!
Yeah, we're out of here!
Fine, go on, I don't care! I don't need you! I got money!
You know, Peter, you used to be a great guy, but ever since you won that lottery... Come on, Joe! This guy!
I'm here to audition for Fiddler on the Roof.
Come right in.
Peter, my God, what the hell are you wearing?
It's a solid gold tuxedo, Lois. I had to fight three rappers down at the nonsense store for this.
Look, Peter, this is not who we are. I'm worried the money is changing this family and not the way you hoped.
Well, I was hoping it would make you shut up, so you're right.
You know, I spoke to Bonnie this morning, and she said you haven't talked to Joe or Quagmire in 2 weeks.
Who cares? I don't need Quagmire. And I certainly don't need Joe. I got money, Joe. That's a good one, money, Joe.
I don't like what this money is doing to us. It's even affecting Brian and Stewie.
I think I'm gonna take a nap.
What, here?
Yeah, I had a giant mobile put in the sky so I can sleep wherever I want. This is nice. I hope that bear comes around soon. That's sort of my favorite. Oh, look, the bear!
And it's not just them. Chris has also been developing some very expensive tastes.
Model glue, sir.
Well, what do we have today?
Today, we have a recent vintage procured just this morning from Michael's hobby shop.
Yes, that's very nice. Bring me my finest rag.
Your fancy rag, sir.
You are relieved for the evening. You don't see poor people doing this!
Lois, don't you understand? We don't got any of our old problems anymore. We don't have to worry about paying bills. We don't have to worry about saving dough. All we gotta do is enjoy ourselves. Interested?
Oh, my God. Peter, it's beautiful. Is it a blood diamond?
Ah, the bloodiest. The two kids who found it were forced to murder each other.
Oh, Peter, I love it.
Hey. You want to watch a DVD of the murder while we do it? I already watched it 8 times, so I know exactly which part I want to blam at. Chris, Meg, now that I'm a rich father, you will try to impress me and I will remain distant. Go.
Say, Dad, did I tell you I got second place in the yacht race?
Sounds like somebody's dad is happier than me right now.
Well, how about this, Dad? The school paper's doing a story about me.
That's because I had it arranged.
I was thinking about joining the army?
No. Meg, as a girl, your life holds no merit. And Chris, try as you may, you will never be as good as your older brother who died. He was good at sports and talking. Now pardon me while I look at Scrimshaw through a magnifying glass. Ah, brave men all, lost sons of New Bedford. That's good, Scrimshaw.
I never thought I'd be having high tea at the Park Barrington every single day.
Yes, it's nice to eat in a sea of white faces, isn't it?
Waiter, have the chef prepare a bucket of your finest caviar and then give it a helicopter tour of the city.
Very good, sir.
Very good indeed. I hope it enjoys it as much as that Maine lobster I ordered.
And over there is the Rhode Island State House, the second largest self-supporting marble dome in North America. Why the am I doing this? I could have just said I did it.
Sir, about your bill.
Oh, don't worry, Carstairs. There's ample gratuity on there for you.
Well, actually, sir, your card has been declined.
Oh, really? Well, I'm sure a brief call to my accountant will resolve this to our mutual satisfaction. Hello, Schnazenstein. This is Peter Griffin. There seems to be some issue with our credit. I told Carstairs you'd set everything straight. What do you mean I'm broke? What about all that money I sent to the Gayman Islands? They did what with it? No, I don't want it back! I'm gonna miss you, Carstairs.
I shall miss you too, sir.
With no one to look after, Carstairs fell into a deep depression from which he never emerged. He died 2 weeks later. Some say of a broken heart.
What, sir?
But that was Carstairs.
I can't believe it! We lost everything!
What do we do now?
Well, seems like our only hope is the lottery. Holy... We won twice and we're right back here again.
We had $150 million and we blew through it in a month.
Yeah, but on the bright side, if this hadn't happened, we never would have met Kyle.
Hey.
Hi. Hello.
Hey, Dad.
Hi.
And that's not even Kyle.
Peter, we can't live like this.
Well, what are we supposed to do, Lois? Everything we had is gone.
We have friends, Peter.
Not anymore, we don't.
They're good people. They'll listen. And they'll care what happens to us, even after everything that's happened.
You know, I'm still young enough you can drop me at the fire station, no questions asked. Well, well, look who it is.
Who is it?
It's me, Peter. I'm standing right here.
This is a glass eye, Peter. They had to remove the one you shot.
Oh, boy, that whole day was a mess, huh?
What happened to you anyway? You look terrible.
Look, you guys, I messed up bad. Winning the lottery was the worst thing that ever happened to me and my family. I thought being rich would solve all my problems, but all it did was make me forget what was important. Like who my real friends are. I don't expect you to forgive me, but if for some reason you do... You can find me in a cardboard box on the corner of Meeting and Thayer.
Peter, wait. That corner's a bit of a hike for me. I'd rather just come see you at home.
What? Where'd you get this kind of money?
The penis enlargement pill you gave me the startup money for. It turned a pretty nice profit. I guess it's only fair that I give you my percentage so you can get your house back.
Quagmire, I don't know what to say. Thank you.
You're welcome. And if it makes you feel better, it was money well spent. Just ask Sandra, the waitress over there. We had a great time last night.
Tough girl. Made it into work.
Boy, I gotta say, it's good to be home.
Yeah, despite all the ups and downs, things turned out for the best. I mean, really, we're no worse off than we were before. Plus, we learned something, and you can't put a price on that.
Look, Lois, we all know what happened. We're all depressed. All right, now let's just go to different rooms and stare blankly out the window saying nothing.
Oh, it's a letter from my fancy private high school.
I'll take this envelope to the refuse, madam.
Oh, thank you, letter butler.
What's that all about?
Oh, it's an invitation to my high school reunion. I went to the Fansington's Academy for Insufferable Girls. Our mascot was a well-dressed woman who yells at valets.
Nice. I'm sure you and Peter will have a great time.
Peter.
Nobody look! This is a private, gross matter.
Right. Do people bring husbands to these things?
You're not thinking of going without them, are you?
Honestly, Brian, these girls come from old money, so they can be pretty stuffy and judgmental.
Well, I'm still available.
But the real outliers were the friends we made along the way. The end.
Oh, hey, Lois.
Wow, Wow, look at you, reading a book, huh?
Oh, yeah, I read everything people leave on planes. I read the Da Vinci Code 4 times.
And I'm not sure the last time I've seen you in your uniform. You really clean up nice. Hey, Glenn, I have this class reunion coming up soon, and I thought maybe it'd be fun if, I don't know, you know, maybe the two of us went together?
What about Peter?
Oh, he hates those things. And football. Climate change?
Well, that is a real problem.
Hey, here's a fun thought. What if you go and pretend to be my husband?
Well, I'm not used to wearing rings above the waist, but what the hell? I'll try anything once.
Where are you going, Mom?
Oh, I'm just heading out for the weekend to visit the Museum of Dusty Vases.
Why don't you just look at all the ones in this house?
So what do we do for dinner? Like, pizza?
No pizza.
Okay, right. So, like, pizza?
No, Peter, not pizza.
Okay, right. Not pizza. So just pizza?
Okay, everyone. I stocked the fridge with healthy food. Your weight is a reflection on me, so no pizza.
Oh, the pizza. Now, that's an idea.
Peter, if you disobey me about the pizza, there will be consequences. Mom's out of town consequences, which, according to the movies, are the worst kind.
Fine. But I'm gonna tweet mean stuff at celebrities that look vaguely like you.
You're going to that reunion, aren't you?
Shh, keep your voice down. Yes, I'm going, but with Quagmire, not Peter. Glenn's gonna pretend to be my husband to impress them.
Are you sure that's a good idea? I mean, it's Quagmire. You know how he feels about you.
Yeah, I know he's gonna try and sleep with me, but I'm a big girl and I can handle Quagmire. I'll be fine.
But
nothing. Fetch!
Oh, not cool, Lois. Very not cool.
All right, she's gone. Now, who wants pizza?
Oh, no. No wife of mine carries her own bags. Oh, my God, that's heavy. What's in these things?
Well, we're here for 2 nights, so my hairdryer, my iron, my free weights, and I thought maybe if I had a minute, I'd rollerblade, my CPAP machine and bedside table.
There's a whole table in here?
Travel Peloton, every robe I've ever owned, and my desktop computer. It's got my email on there.
Lois, I have an umbilical hernia.
They're on rollers.
Oh.
Okay, so I booked us a suite so that we can keep up the appearance of being married, but still sleep in separate rooms.
Like John Krasinski and Emily Blunt?
Exactly.
Oh, Pizza Man's here. Do I look okay? I know, that one has a mind of its own.
Here's your pie. May I use your bathroom?
Absolutely. We'll be out here eating pizza like we're in an 80s commercial.
Smile in your family's face. It's pizza night. Eye contact with your son. He's gonna take a stringy bite. The obesity epidemic was starting to take hold. So stuff your face with pizza before it gets too cold. Before it gets too cold, yeah.
Pizza! It's probably just the pizza talking. But I love you guys.
The pizza guy's car is still running outside.
4 tires, not one of them the same.
Is that guy still on the can?
I'll check.
Let's all check.
I think he's had a heart attack. He's dead.
Oh my God, Dad, this is terrible.
I know. Your mother is gonna find out we had pizza.
Is not the room I reserved. This is the honeymoon suite.
Was that this is the honeymoon, comma, suite? Or like room?
Oh, you're not gonna get away with this. I am gonna tweet mean stuff at celebrities that look vaguely like you.
Whoa, I had nothing to do with this.
Then how did this happen?
Well, I'm a platinum member at all the hotel chains, so they probably just saw my name and upgraded us.
Well, I don't know if I'm comfortable with this.
Well, no problem. Let me call the front desk and see if they can switch us to a room with two beds. Ah, yes, we were wondering if we might be able to switch rooms. Uh-huh. I see, so just a windowless single with no water pressure?
No, you know what? It's fine. We're already here.
My wife says no, it's fine. We're already here. Oh, you heard that. Okay, thanks anyway.
But don't get any ideas, because nothing is going to happen between us.
You have nothing to worry about. I'll be more of a gentleman than John Wayne Bobbitt with his second wife.
Hey, honey, would you take out the trash?
Yes, yeah, absolutely. Love it, love it. What else?
Well, I have been dying to see that new Rebel Wilson movie. I hear she raps, like, a lot.
Let's just do this.
Okay, we have to get rid of this body so your mom can't connect us with the pizza. Anybody got any ideas?
We could put a yarmulke on him and dump him in the town square. Pretend it's a hate crime.
Chris, come on. Where are we going to get a yarmulke?
We should float him with balloons like an up. Then he's the sky's problem.
Oh, my God. He got a text.
Brian, get it. I'm not fishing it out of his pants because I'm into chicks. Oh, no. This means there are still undelivered pizzas in his car.
The restaurant's gonna know ours was the last one he dropped off before he disappeared.
Oh my God, that means Mom will find out.
Which means we gotta deliver the rest of his pizzas, and we'll leave him and his car at the last stop.
Well, if we're going in the car, that means I can take the iPad. Mom said. Okay, it's showtime.
Ladies, you're looking wealthy tonight. I'd like you to meet my husband. We're married, hence the rings.
Enchanté. I'm a pilot and I read books.
This is Madison Lexington Broadway. She runs a scholarship for underprivileged WASPs who can only afford Cornell.
My father shoots elephants.
And Vivian Yacht Brunch, who sailed directly into the building from Turks and Caicos.
I summer in Antibes and I winter in the spring.
And of course, Scowly Tight Anus, the granddaughter of both Henry Tight and Randolph Anus.
We were a clipping on the Jay Leno program.
May I say that you have the breasts of an obese woman and the arms of an anorexic?
Oh! No!
Hey, this is a lot of fun for everybody. Do you mind if I upstage you at your job? Attention, everybody. This is your captain. I'm not going to turn on the fasten seatbelt sign. You guys can do whatever you want.
Now I get it. I'm sorry I played your saxophone.
God, this car is depressing. He's got 3 ashtrays in use.
Can you put on some music?
There's no CD player. Just a Discman with a cassette plug-in.
You ever heard of a band called Special Delivery? Oh, no, it's his band. Oh, no. Oh, they're all in uniforms. God bless them. Dying on a stranger's toilet seat is bad, but this is real bad.
Dad, let's get back to the pizzas.
Right. We deliver the pizzas, and nobody calls the police. Where's our first stop?
The police station.
There are cameras everywhere. We can't be seen leaving those pizzas.
But he can.
Good thinking, Chris. All those in favor of Meg getting in the dead guy's clothes with him and scarecrowing him in, raise your hand.
Fine, I'll do it. But only because I'm starved for human contact and he's not fully cold yet.
Well, if it isn't Georgie, my 4th best friend, in the weirdly gray flesh. Haven't seen you since I ordered that calzone. Hey, I hate to be the bearer of bad shoes, but your sneaker's untied. Hey, I heard your guitar got stolen, so I swiped you a new one from the evidence locker. It used to belong to Martin Screlly, surprisingly soulful balladeer. Okay, fine, you can play me a song to thank me. I'm hearing a little Clapton mixed with hearing loss from going to the gun range too much.
We're one short on the suspect lineup. Know anyone who could fill in?
Well, the perpetrator was doing a highly choreographed routine during the assault, so number three, please step forward and perform the zombie dance from Thriller.
Oh, come on!
5, 6, 7, 8!
Phew! That was close. I'm glad to be done delivering to places that are too risky to walk a dead body into. What's next?
The cadaver dog training facility.
I've been waiting for you, Georgie. I haven't eaten all day.
The pizza guy's having a secret affair.
Oh, to be single and dead again, huh, Chris? Last stop. I ordered another pizza.
Thank you all for coming tonight. On your way out, please take a complimentary au pair. And of course, au pair is French for with jugs.
Your husband is remarkable. I am hereby changing his designation from charming to a triumph.
Hear, hear. Before you, the one who'd done the best in our group was Joan. She was married to a functioning alcoholic.
All our husbands were Christmas suicides.
Well, what can I say? I'm a lucky woman.
By the way, Lois, when we get back to our room, you can choose the streaming service we watch tonight.
Even Crackle?
Even Crackle.
Oh, thanks for being a great husband tonight. I mean, when you got that standing ovation for comparing the estate tax to the Holocaust, I felt like the belle of the ball.
I really enjoyed spending time with you, too. So?
He's a good guy. Let him down easy. When he goes for the kiss, just tell him that... Roseburn! That's the actress I was trying to remember earlier. Always good, but never a star. Okay, I'll text Bonnie about that later.
I want you to meet the cocktail waitress I'm about to sleep with.
What?
This is Jenna. You might remember her boobs from hovering over your shoulder while pouring wine. I know I do.
I remember you. You're the lady who moved her chair 4 times because of the air conditioning and then asked the band if they could play a little quieter.
2 maracas. We get it. You like to shake stuff, but don't upstage the entrees.
Anyway, we're taking off now. Enjoy Crackle.
I can't believe this. Well, I guess I could always go down to the business center and get passively hit on by all the losers.
All right, that's 1 ticket. Economy plus. Checking bags, several. Okay, and print. And time to go home. I'm not staying here, I just don't own a printer.
Look who decided to show up.
Hey, Lois. That was some night. You'll be happy to know I was able to perform on a 4-inch-thick futon in front of 3 roommates.
You know, the hotel sent champagne up for us last night.
Oh, why didn't you send it to me and Jenna? Well, no sense wasting it. Hey, did you end up working out in the morning like you said you were gonna? What was it, 40 minutes cardio, then a Pilates class? Did you do both of those?
No, I didn't do both of those.
So just one?
I did neither of them.
Ouch. Well, thanks again for inviting me. This has been fun. First pee afterwards. Whoa! Lois, I'm using all the towels. And then I said, not today, geese. And I landed that passenger plane on the Hudson.
As someone who didn't watch the news in 2009 and doesn't care for Tom Hanks films, that is the most riveting story I've ever heard.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your brunch captain speaking. It's gonna be a bumpy ride, cause I'm making mimosas.
The only thing bumpy around here is that strained airplane metaphor.
What is this, mutters against drunk driving? Lois, have a drink. Ladies, I took the liberty of requesting our meal be soy-free, meat-free, gluten-free, dairy-free, cage-free, carb-free, and cruelty-free. And then I snuck you each a cinnamon bun because all that other stuff's for Democrats.
Oh, he is wonderful. Lois, where did you find him?
Oh, you think he's so wonderful? Last night, he screwed the cocktail waitress.
I'm sorry, ladies. I have deceived you. So I'll just collect my free au pair.
and one for my wife. And I'll be on my way. What is your problem?
Get away from me!
What's going on with you? I thought I made such a good impression. We had those ladies fooled.
Just leave me alone, Glenn.
I did exactly what you wanted. I didn't make a move. I didn't even come close.
That's the problem.
You wanted me to?
I wanted you to try. I wanted you to try. Then I could shoot you down and feel sexually desirable and morally superior.
But you're both those things.
And you say that now, but last night you were out boinking that waitress. Now, how do you think that made me feel, huh? It made me feel like my best years are behind me.
Well, that's not true at all. I didn't make a move on you because you're my best friend's wife.
That is true.
Besides, you know me. I'm not a one-gal guy. Last night I was with Jenna for only 4 hours, and I cheated on her with a woman who was fixing the ice machine. Hands were a little cold, but we got there.
I used that ice.
Hopefully before 2:30 a.m. Look, if you wanted a decent guy who's only been into you and only you, you should have brought Peter.
You know what? You're right. So what if he drinks too much? So what if he weighs too much? So what if he thinks Scrappy Doo is the better do? He's a loyal husband and a good man. Oh, I should never have been embarrassed to bring him. And I shouldn't need the attention of another man to feel sexy and young.
That's right. Hey, why don't we continue our discussion in the shower? A little wet-a-tit.
How dare you! And thank you.
All right, Lois is gonna be home soon, so we gotta fix this now.
Why don't we just shove him in the sewer? Let the clowns have at him.
I'm good with anything that keeps Pennywise off my jock.
Sounds like a plan.
Hold on, Peter. This feels wrong. We can't just dump him face down into raw sewage without saying a few words.
You're right, Brian. I'll do the honors. It feels like just yesterday when he came into our lives carrying a pizza we bought. I always loved how he looked around the house a little too much while I was digging the money out of my wallet. And who can forget his license plate number? 7G-something-something-5. More sweat than you used to seeing on a fella, but that's what moisture-wicking shirts are for. His nails were dirty, but his heart was pure. Okay, time to drop him in a river of dung. He's stuck!
Oh, crap, it's Lois!
Peter, what the hell is going on? You ordered pizza, didn't you?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, I don't care. I love you, Peter. And I have a confession for you. I went to my high school reunion this weekend, and I didn't invite you.
What? Thank you! Oh, thank you!
We now return to Guy Friends.
So, you must be pretty pumped.
For what?
Oh, Olympics?
Oh, yeah. I guess that's starting soon.
I thought you were a big Olympics guy.
Yeah, I like them okay.
Huh.
Guy Friends. A computer made us roommates in college. That's why we're friends. Guy Friends!
Mail's here.
Any flyers of Hispanic women running for city council?
Yeah, there is.
Thank you.
Peter, you got a letter from your sister Karen.
What? You've got a sister, Dad? How come we've never met her?
Is she a prim and proper aunt or a big, fat, dirty aunt?
I have no obligation to tell any of you anything.
Mr. Griffin has shown good faith in appearing here today and will not be subjected to this sort of hostile interrogation.
Your father doesn't like to talk about his sister, Meg. They've never really gotten along.
Wow, Peter, in all the years I've known you, you've never even mentioned a sister.
Big deal. I don't talk about my sister. I also don't talk about that tickling uncle. All right, Uncle Dan, remember, no tickling.
Hey, you got it.
You didn't say anything about Uncle Neil.
Whose uncle are you?
It says here your sister's coming for Thanksgiving.
She what?
If we're having guests, can I invite Rosario Vargas from the 3rd District, a leader you can depend on?
I don't want Karen here.
Peter, you've been avoiding your sister for too long. Besides, she says she's been having Thanksgiving with your mother for the last 20 years. And now that your mom has passed, she'd like to spend Thanksgiving with you.
No.
Peter, Karen's coming, and that's that.
How cool! I didn't even know I had an aunt. I can't wait to meet her.
Look, I'm telling you guys, it's gonna be a disaster. Just like the alternate ending of Back to the Future.
Well, if I'm gonna disappear into nothing, I might as well bang my mom. Hey, Lorraine, wait up!
Harry, my name's Marty. I'm in a picture. To be contenders.
We now return to The Cosby Show, knowing what we know now.
Huh. I was so busy not seeing color, I didn't see the raping either.
Okay, everyone. It'll be another hour before the turkey's done, but I made more appetizers.
Ooh, grape jelly on a Triscuit. You're a whiz. Well, 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 slow down. Save your appetite. I don't think I haven't noticed you've already had two drinks.
You're like all the worst parts of a girlfriend.
Ah, that must be Karen.
I'll get it. And Karen?
And you must be Meg.
Do that to me!
Wow, it's so cool that I've got an aunt I didn't know about.
Wow, Karen, I'm so happy you could make it.
Lois Pewterschmidt, the one that got away. I'm just joshing, kid. Auntie's not a biscuit bumper.
I'm not either.
Peter, come say hello to your sister.
Fine. Hey, Karen, welcome to our...
Bring it in, pee-pee!
I like her.
Hello. I am City Councilwoman Rosario Vargas. Quahog doesn't work if it doesn't work for all of us.
That's a beautiful pantsuit, Miss Vargas.
Wow, Karen, nice to meet you. I'm Glenn Quagmire. I didn't know Peter even had a sister.
What are you, ashamed of me, Chin Nuts?
Oh my God, his chin kind of does look like nuts.
Ha ha! I never noticed that!
How could you not notice it? Watch this! I'll punch him in the nuts!
That's sort of clever.
Wait a second, I know you. You're that lady wrestler.
Yeah, he's right. What do they call you again?
Heavy Flow! You're Heavy Flow!
In the flesh and blood.
Gross.
Man, you're amazing! I remember when you called out Andrea the Giant the day after September 11th.
What just happened was a national tragedy, but it's nothing compared to what I'm gonna do to Andrea the Giant! We will never forget what happened yesterday, but you'll also never forget what's gonna happen September 17th at the Jack with Jay Sports Arena!
Peter, I can't believe you've kept your sister a secret. She's amazing!
Yeah, she's crazy strong, like Superman on a date.
Yeah, I wasn't here, but I heard her scream, so I came flying in and found her like this.
It's weird. Same cause of death as those three guys in that local public bathroom.
Unsolvable.
Now do you see why I didn't want Karen here, Lois? She terrorized me my whole childhood. Now she's got to embarrass me in front of my friends?
Peter, Bonnie just changed Joe on the table. What are you worried about?
Still, I don't want to go back out there.
Look, I know you've had your differences, but Karen's your sister. And you're grown-ups now. Can't you just go out there and pretend to have a good time?
Fine, I'll play along. I guess I've lied before.
Where are you going?
Home.
Where's home?
The White House. Okay, I'm here. This is my house. You can go now. Thanks for taking me home.
Go ahead. Go inside.
I will. You can drive away now.
No. I want to make sure you get inside safe.
Yeah, but I got to look through the mail first. You know how it is. Really, I insist. It's totally okay. Go.
At this point, it's more about me than it is you. It's a bad neighborhood. If I don't see you go inside, I'll be thinking about it all night.
Come on in, Mr. President.
And then so I'm like, Peter, how was I supposed to know you didn't want your teammates to know you wore a bra?
It was a custom-designed sports halter top.
More stories! More stories!
Hey, tell one where Peter is a nincompoop. Or maybe a silly Billy. Oh, man.
Okay, let's just carve the turkey.
Oh, and Karen already carved it.
She did? But that's my thing. I always do my are you a leg man or a breast man joke.
And Karen did that, too. It was hilarious.
I never really got it until she said it.
Hey, Karen, later you gotta show us some of your wrestling holds.
Yeah, what's that trademark finishing move of yours?
The Toxic Shock.
Oh, yeah, that move is badass. You're awesome. Know what else is awesome? The stuffing.
Thank you, Glenn.
You're welcome. I'm in a good mood.
Sure, what the hell? I'll show you my moves. Maybe after dinner.
No, the family football game is after dinner. We do it every year.
Peter, calm down. You're making a scene.
It's not my fault, Lois. She's ruining Thanksgiving. The way Tim Burton ruined the 4th of July.
Touchstone Pictures presents Happy 4th of July, Jack Skellington.
Spooky, happy, spooky, happy. Weirdness, weirdness, spooky, happy. La, la, la. Weirdness, weirdness, patriotic weirdness. Barbecuing human heads. Every president is dead. Everybody's gonna die. Have a dark and dead July.
Fat chicks with black hair get tattoos of me.
God, I love this time of year. It's just past all the amazing colors of fall and before the white of winter. Just brown and gray. Magical.
All right, let's do this.
All right, listen up. I'm the captain. The teams are chosen by a lottery system where
And Karen, can I be on your team?
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, sure. I'll take, Meg, Skinny, Hot Chocolate, and the bus. Pee-pee, you get the crumbs. Let's go.
All right, let's do it, Pop. I'm gonna make some sports points for you.
We'll kick off.
Hey, time out. Did anyone tape the parade? Please tell me someone taped the parade.
Oh my God, she's doing the Toxic Shock!
You're a jerk, Karen!
What the hell was that?
That's his stutter. And whenever he stutters, he usually pees his pants.
No, I don't.
So this is football. I like it.
Hi, Dad. Look, I just want you to know I feel bad about what happened with you and Aunt Karen the other day.
Oh, you mean when she put me in that no-bottom James Bond chair and assaulted my grundle?
I didn't even know about that.
Well, that's because it didn't happen. I'd kick her ass if she tried something like that.
Dad, stop. Even I can see that your sister's a huge bully. And trust me, I know more about getting bullied than anyone.
You do? How?
Man, I love that song.
Dad, what I'm trying to tell you is, I now see why you've been so tough on me all these years.
Because it makes my friends laugh?
No, because that's how Aunt Karen treated you when you were a kid. That's right, and that's why you need to confront Karen.
Oh, no, I can't do that. I tried for years to stand up to her. Nothing ever worked.
What, so now you're gonna quit? You can't quit. What if Muhammad Ali had quit?
Ah, my grandchildren. Who would like me to read them a book or maybe paint their name on a grain of rice?
Honey, dinner time.
Ah, my favorite, hot soup. Right in there.
Dad, I know you can stand up to Aunt Karen. And maybe, if you finally do, she'll stop terrorizing you and you won't have to take it out on me for the rest of my life.
You know what, Meg? You're right. I'm gonna do it.
You are?
Damn right.
Yay, Dad!
I am gonna become a lady wrestler and defeat Heavy Flo in the ring.
Wait, what? No! What? I meant go talk to her.
Nope, it's gotta be a lady wrestling match.
Hey, Meg, Thanksgiving's over. Come help me with the Christmas decorations. Meg! Help me with the Christmas decorations!
Comments? Questions?
What the hell are you...
I'm sorry, Chris had his hand up first. Chris?
What's the capital of Maryland?
I do not know, but that's a very good question. Now, Lois.
Peter, what the hell are you doing?
First, it's not Peter. When I am in this outfit, I am Maxie Petty, the fiercest enemy of Heavy Flo.
Peter, you look... Okay, that's clever. But Peter, you look ridiculous. Take that off. If you want to settle things with your sister, just go talk to her.
Now, Lois, the only way to settle a family dispute is in the cage. I mean, you don't understand. Karen made me feel worse than a guy getting cut from a baseball team.
You wanted to see me, Coach?
I'm sorry, Kyle. You can't do this boring, stupid thing with us.
right, Peter, your sister's the real deal, so I arranged for you to get some combat pointers from my old buddy, Steven Seagal.
This fat guy?
Yep. Go on, ask him anything.
Why are you so fat?
Okay, ask him about anything but his weight.
You act Asian, you look Native American, your name is possibly Jewish. What are you?
Hey, fat. All right, Peter. Most professional wrestlers become addicted to painkillers at some point, so I figure why don't we just start now?
Okay. Yeah, I'm in. Where you getting all these?
Stepdaughter's purse. Ain't my problem. Man, I love putting my hand down my pants when I'm on drugs.
We should just go live on a boat in some guy's backyard.
So you gonna do that wrestling stuff?
Nah, I'm gonna stick with these. I would crime for more of these.
Okay, now if you're gonna defeat your sister in the ring, you gotta get to the root of your fears. We gotta go back to your childhood, so I'm gonna hypnotize you. Okay, go back. Now we need to go back in time.
My jeans are husky.
Okay, further. Further, little further. Now open your eyes and tell me what you see.
I see the six stations of the Lord's Order, and they will all burn.
Okay, too far, too far, too far. Come back, come back, come back.
Hey, can I make my husky jeans into cutoffs for swimming?
Ah, forget it. You're ready.
Yeah, Peter, I think you're gonna win.
All right. Hey, thanks for all your help, you guys. You know, there's only two things I've wanted to do my whole life. Put my sister in her place and go to Chico's Monkey Farm.
Chico's Monkey Farm. Come and have a howling good time.
Ooh, ooh.
Chico's Monkey Farm, the only drive-thru monkey farm in northern southern Rhode Island.
Ooh-ha!
Chico's Monkey Farm, after a prolonged litigation, we're finally open again.
Ooh-ha!
Chico's Monkey Farm, there's a fair amount of paperwork before you get to see a monkey, so allow for extra time.
Ooh-ha!
Chico's Monkey Farm, keep your windows rolled up, cause the monkeys will pry them open and they're known to strangle kids.
Chico's Monkey Farm, now open pending how it goes.
And we've got quite a match tonight between Heavy Flo and another woman whose name I've forgotten, but I'm sure is a gross pun.
Right you are, Bill. Tonight she's up against Her Majesty's Secret Cervix. Interesting fact, these two gals have over 8 meters of ass crack between them. One!
It's over, and once again, a Heavy Flo has ruined another ladies' evening.
You ain't no champ. Not till you go through me.
Who the hell are you?
I'm Maxie Patty, which is short for Maxine Patricia. I was named after my father, Maxwell Patrick. But that's enough about me. I'm here to kick your ass.
Get out of here. I'm not fighting some fat loser from the crowd.
Huh. It looks like this Heavy Flo is pee, because you're yellow.
Well, that didn't quite track, but the crowd seems to be on board.
It sure does. Looks like Heavy Flo has a challenger.
All right, get up here, but make it quick. I got a Lampoon reunion to get to.
Heavy Flo always finding a way to drop her Harvard degree into conversation.
Yes, very off-putting, Bill. Those of us who went to Harvard really don't appreciate it.
Karen!
Karen? Peter, is that you? What are you doing here?
Something I should have done a long time ago. I'm tired of you bullying me. You're going down.
Butt scratcher!
Butt scratcher!
She's taking it too far. Heavy Flo is gonna break this girl's arms.
Woman's arms. Come on, Bill.
No! Don't! Stewie! He's in charge of the show now!
Say hello to Teen LaQuifa!
One, two, three! I don't believe it! Heavy Flo is down and we have a new champion!
A
I tell you, this is one for the books if anyone kept track of this nonsense.
Wow, you really saved me. Thanks, stranger.
Dad, it's me.
Meg? It was you who saved me?
That's right, Dad.
Wow, even after all the crummy stuff I've done to you? But why?
Because you're my dad, and I couldn't stand by and watch you get hurt.
Wow. Thanks, Meg. You know, that's something even my own mom and dad never did for me. They just stood by and let Karen pick on me.
Well, you deserve better. We all do.
You know, Meg, I'm really sorry I treated you so badly over the years. I guess I was taking out all the pain I felt on you.
I understand. Better than anybody. But I still love you, Dad.
I love you too, Meg.
Did somebody order a hot-ass bitch in this lady? Oh, you're alive. Sorry, I was told I was in charge now. Well, if you die, this is kind of the creative direction I'm leaning toward.
Well, I'm proud of you, Dad. You finally stood up for yourself.
So, Peter, have you talked to Karen?
I called like 4 times, but she's not out of the coma yet. Apparently they usually use fake chairs, but Meg used a real one.
Do they think she's gonna survive?
It could go either way. Hello? No, I think I'm a different blood type. No, I don't want to check. Doctor says there's nothing they can do.
Welcome to our home, and thank you all so much for coming to celebrate our dear Lois and her wonderful husband, Peter. I know Carter wanted to say a few words.
Poor, unfunny, fat. Oh, and the sprinklers come on at 4. I don't know how to change that, so we have until then.
Beautifully said.
Wow. A lot of years for us.
Uh-huh.
Hey, so what do you think about dinner?
Oh, God, I'm so tired of thinking about dinner. I don't know.
Well, what are you in the mood for?
Okay, that's just another version of the same question. Oh, I've collected 9 finalists for our new end table. We should talk.
Will each one be instantly overcrowded by 3 items?
Absolutely.
Great. So where do we land dinner-wise?
If I could have everyone's attention, it's time to present Peter and Lois with a very special anniversary gift.
Yes, we really went all out this year.
Okay, we is an insane characterization, but here it is. A brand new Range Rider. That's it? Ah, crap, it looks so much bigger in the Sky Mall magazine.
That's a rookie move, man.
Lois, I'm sorry. I didn't realize it was a toy car for a child. I can...
It's fine, Daddy, really. I bet Stewie might enjoy playing with it.
Will there be, like, a replacement gift, or no?
That's very sweet, Lois. Always thinking of others.
Amazon gift card?
It's the thought that counts, Daddy, and it was a very nice thought.
$20 bill cupped in a handshake?
I'm gonna go change out of this wetsuit.
Wow, a white Range Rider SUV! Hey, what was Ari's wife's name on Entourage?
Can't remember. Doesn't matter. I'm Ari's wife.
Good work today, Mom Bathing Suit. See you on Labor Day.
Now wash it off. It's my fault for over-guacking the chip.
Joe, I'm in here!
Sorry, I didn't realize. I'm sorry, I'm leaving!
I feel more violated than Miss Pac-Man. So, Lois, you would not believe the night Joe and I had last night.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was easily some of the best sex of our entire marriage. And for the first time in 9 years, Joe was able to achieve manhood. You know, without a pill, a shot, or a pump.
Oh, you don't say.
It was crazy. I can't even count all the different positions Joe let me carefully arrange his limp body into.
Oh, wow, I'm so happy you two were able to rekindle that spark.
Whoops, gotta go. I've got lunch with the girls.
Well, I thought I was one of the girls.
You're one of the gals.
Oh, no. What am I gonna do? I bet Joe was only able to do it because he was thinking of me. Chris?
I've been caught, but I'll never be sorry.
Boy, I went hard at my fat guy's wrestling club today.
I understood that with great reward comes great risk.
Hey, Bri, check out my new whip. Pretty cool, huh?
You might even say it's a cool
quick... Yeah, I'm not doing that.
Oh, you're no fun.
I will say, though, it seems like you're really embracing the Range Rider lifestyle.
Oh, this thing's the best. J.D. Power & Associates called it the best car for slamming on your brakes at a crosswalk while texting. Would you believe this is the same model Reese Witherspoon yells at her husband in?
I would believe that, yes.
Look, you can even change the navigation system to be her voice.
I am an American citizen. Turn left at the light.
The only thing is, 8 different people spoke to me in Farsi. I think they just assumed I'm Persian.
Seems right.
There's a whole section of the owner's manual that's very anti-Israel.
Aren't you forgetting your dry cleaning?
Oh, Carmen will get that.
Who's Carmen?
Oh my God, you're right. It's Rosalita. That stays on this curb. Rosalita! Como esta?
I'm Sarah McLachlan. And for just $1 a day, you can help save one of these abused and terrified grips from the Ellen DeGeneres Show. Whether it's a Teamster sobbing in his car after work, or a camera operator having a sandwich slapped out of his hand just for making eye contact, they need your help. So please, give today. Because no one should have to spend Thanksgiving watching a millionaire try on sweaters.
Kids, you really gotta clean the dog poop off your shoes right when it happens. It's so much harder to get it off once it's dried.
You're more than welcome to return to the workforce.
I think I'm cleaning diarrhea. I think I'm cleaning diarrhea. I really think so. Lois Griffin, you are adding spice to that marriage. Wow, look at me, making a difference for those in need.
Would you like to add a dollar to your bill to fight cancer?
No, I gave a disabled guy an erection. Okay, now time to work some of that magic on my man.
Hey, Lois! Lois, check it out! I think James Cromwell is on this little house on the prairie.
Actually, what do you say tonight I turn the TV off and turn you on?
What are you, drunk? And where are the wet ones? You know I need a cautionary wipe.
Stop throwing them out in the bedside trash!
I don't!
The hell you don't! I mean, it's all right. Let's not talk about that, hmm? Let's talk about how steamy it's getting in here.
That would be a Bertucci's burp cloud with a Mr. Pibb fart cloud chaser. Hence the need for wet ones. Hey, while you're in there, will you sign Meg's permission slip for the historic Slater Mill? I left it at the foot of the toilet between my shoes.
I don't have to show you my ID. I'm Reese Witherspoon. You have arrived at your destination.
Oh, thank God. Stewie, you got my text.
Yeah, didn't so much get them as was panic startled awake by them.
I really am in no condition to drive home. It was dog trivia night. And people kept buying me shots. I almost... Okay, oh, pull over! Pull over! Ah, are you gonna puke? Ah, not in the car!
Okay, here, aim it into this TCBY cup.
Okay, I'm okay.
You good?
Yeah, sorry, for a second.
Ah, no, it's a yogurt cup, Ryan! No, not on the seats! The cup, the cup!
Look, this is gonna sound racist, but...
Stop.
No, hear me out. It's just
stop.
All I'm saying is...
Stop!
It's just stop! Norwegians can't dance!
Oh, that's actually not as bad as I thought it would be.
It is clearly he has not seen me dance around the Skansen tree on Julafton, for true, yeah?
Yeah, we can do hopping like lutefisk in the almond pot.
Family Guy, we googled Norway for this joke.
I manage the entire teacher appreciation night, and I'm supposed to accept second vice president?
They are disrespecting you, Donna. They are disrespecting you.
No doubt. What about you?
Did the airline give you the Miami route yet?
They say I'm next in line.
They are disrespecting you, Glenn. They are disrespecting you.
Okay, see you next week.
Yeah, you will. And thanks for signing my Facebook petition about the speed bumps. We'll get them. What the hell?
All right, Joe, it's showtime.
What is she doing? It's not even sunny. Oh my God, she's putting on some kind of weird show for Joe. This is a betrayal. Peter deserves to know. He deserves to know right away. Ugh, don't make me do a voice call. I'll fire him a text down the line. Hey, thanks for coming out with just me, Peter. There's something very important I need to talk to you about.
Am I adopted?
What? No, what?
Are you getting divorced?
I'm not even married.
We're moving again because of the army?
Well, it's a big move up for me, and you're going to get your own room. And I mean, no, that's not... Look, what I'm trying to tell you is I saw Lois strutting around your front yard, basically putting on a sex show for Joe, and he was into it.
What? He was? Are you sure?
Trust me, Peter, when it comes to sex, I know what I'm talking about. Like, did you know 46% of people picture someone else when they're having sex with their spouse?
Wow, did you read that in an article?
Nope, I do all my own research.
Mm.
Who are you thinking of right now?
Chris Pine.
Huh, he's doing well this cycle.
Damn it, I'll teach Joe to ogle my wife.
Oh, hey, Peter. What are you clenching in that fist there?
Well, that was sadder than what I was going for. Well, at least it's over. Oh, God, those are all final notice wheelchair bills. Not a good day for Joe. Not a good day for Joe.
Peter, this is insane! I can't believe you would beat up your own friend.
What, can you blame me? After the sick show you two were putting on out there?
Now, fine, Peter. So what if I was putting on a show? At least someone was in the audience. And maybe ask yourself why I'd even feel I have to do that. I come out of the bathroom in my underwear last night, and all you want to do is look at James Cromwell.
It was weird. He had most of his hair.
You don't find me attractive anymore.
Oh, come on. It's not you. It's time. After all these years of marriage, your naked body has pretty much no effect on me anymore. It's basically like staring at a chair from the DMV.
Well, sue me for trying to help reignite the passion in another couple's marriage. I can't seem to do it in my own.
That's not what you're doing. You're flaunting yourself in front of the whole neighborhood just to boost your own ego.
All right, Peter. I'll be honest with you.
We're moving again because of the army?
What? No, we're talking about Joe.
All right, we're moving again because Joe's in the army. I don't want to move to Omaha. My friends are here.
What is this? What do you think you're doing?
Not that it's any of your business, Lois, but I'm fighting fire with fire. Now, if you need me, I'll be chopping wood out front when all the stroller moms go by.
Oh!
That's right, ladies. Oh. I'll be here all morning, turning small pieces of wood into even smaller pieces of wood for no reason.
Okay, so for purposes of the claim, what was the cause of the accident?
Yeah, I don't know how that thing broke.
Well, I see your neighbor has a Nest camera.
That was from a previous attempt. I thought I looked hot, but then the paperboy laughed. Unless you think it worked?
Sir, I'm just trying to find out what happened with the window and head home to eat a Runeberg tort. A dessert from Finland.
Oh, yes, named after the Finnish national poet, Johan Ludvig Runeberg.
We kind of fell down a rabbit hole on those countries up there.
Okay, any better?
Now I just smell Febreze and vomit.
Stupid dog!
Seems like having a car is a real pain.
God, it's the worst. I mean, no way! Having a car is a dream! And having an expensive car you're constantly terrified about getting dinged or dirtied, that's like the best thing you can hope for! Up, text from Brian. Let me know if you're going on a Tums run. Ugh, so passive-aggressive. Do you need Tums? All right, Chris, as long as I'm going, do you need anything?
Well, if you're going on a Desinex run, I wouldn't say no.
Do you need Desinex?
Only if you're going on a run.
Hey, Joe. I was wondering if you needed to borrow a cup of sugar.
No thanks, Lois. And also, that's not how the sugar thing usually works.
Well, I just...
Lois, you can stop with the phony excuses. I know why you've been doing what you're doing, and I think it's better if you stop.
But, Joe, I just...
Look, I've given this tremendous thought wondering if the reason I became so excited by all that's happened is that Peter's a good friend, and perhaps the affection you two share was briefly channeled towards me as a reminder and renewal of the importance of maintaining a deep sense of wonder and curiosity about life. But then I realized it was mostly about seeing side boob. That was not my wife's side boob. It just has to be different. I can't stress that enough.
But I'm okay with that, Joe.
Sorry, Lois, I can't do this to Peter, but please know that you have done a great service for my and Bonnie's sex life.
Oh, I understand. Bye, Joe.
Say, Lois.
Yes?
You're not going on a catheter run by any chance, are you?
Do you need me to get your catheters?
Only if you're going on a run.
Stop kicking my seat! That's it. If I have to stop this car, there'll be no popsicles. Probably no popsicles.
La 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 la, simple life on a big wheel, very unencumbered.
Ah! Rupert! Rupert, talk to me! How many fingers am I holding up? Two? No, it's three! Okay, the thumb isn't a finger, you're right. So glad you're okay to point that out. Still, I thought I'd lost you. Oh, this car has brought me nothing but trouble. Well, there's only one thing to do. I don't know, I just parked it on the street, and when I woke up this morning, it was gone.
Well, this Nest camera footage shows you dousing it in gasoline and setting it ablaze.
I have Nest cam footage of you pleasuring yourself in our hedges.
Is it check okay?
Yeah, I did a good thing for Joe and Bonnie's marriage. It's not about me, it's about them. And if I could do it for Joe, I can do it for a whole hospital wing of disabled veterans. Lois Griffin, reporting for duty.
What possessed you to impersonate a nurse and give seven addled Korean War veterans sponge baths?
I'm a sexually desirable woman! Peter, what are you doing here?
I smushed my thing up against a glass of a Lululemon. I'm really sorry for all the stuff I said earlier.
Oh, me too.
It's just, after all these years, when I look at you, all I see is dealing with the kids, figuring out meals, going through the mail. It's great that Joe could see you like you used to be, but for me, it's getting harder.
No, it's my fault, too. I've taken us for granted. And it felt so nice to be seen as the person I used to think I was.
Truth is, eventually I'd probably get bored with any woman. Might as well get bored with the woman I love.
Well, I can sit here and tell you today I'm as bored with you as I've ever been. I love you.
I love you too, Lois. Wow. You know, I never seen you in a nurse's outfit before.
And I've never seen you dressed as prom night Tarzan?
I'm a Chippendales dancer.
Huh? Chippendales? I know they have a big cover charge. How much is the uncover charge?
For you, it's $35, because you didn't bring enough people to qualify for the group rate. But it does include a $12 bottle of Costco champagne that we're going to tell you is worth $100.
Why? But, Peter, you're bad at this.
No, you argue back, and then we get all hot. I'm raising two children alone in a single apartment.
Okay, I'm back in. Boy, you really made some mistakes in your life, haven't you, you little piece of trash?
There's someone else in here.
Oh, my God!
What the hell? Principal Shepard, you're in here too?
Yeah, I got into a slap fight with the Applebee's hostess because they wouldn't turn on Fox News.
You know what? We'll wait till we get home. We're so sorry.
For what? I didn't tell you to stop.
Okay. Peter!
Oh, Lois!
Can you call out the names of garbage people from Fox News?
Oh, Hannity!
Oh, Tucker!
Oh, Judge Jeanine!
Oh, Steve Doocy!
Who's that terrible blonde lady whose own family hates her?
Laura Ingraham.
Oh, Laura Ingraham! Yes! Oh, Wow, Peter, I'm so glad we were able to discover this new level of intimacy. I've never felt so connected to you.
Me either. And I never knew your biggest fantasy was to do it as a cat from a children's book.
For most of the night, Peter gooshed on her flumpkus. She crumpled his wansit. He boobled her bumpkus. The bangle bong lasted till first break of day. 6 times that night she screamed, Zazu Kazay!
The end. Good night, Stewie.
Don't read me books that you write.
Say, you fellas know if Jerome serves dessert here? I got a real hankering for pudding.
That's so weird. I was just thinking about pudding on the way over here.
Okay, well, you two are clearly in love. But I could also go for some pudding.
Why we all got pudding on the brain?
It's gotta be that new billboard advertising pudding on the highway. We all drove past it on the way here.
Huh. Well, that's no surprise. Everyone in my house can get very excited by a good ad campaign. Lois, it's back!
I heard, Peter! I heard!
Kids, it's happening! Get your coats! This is what we practiced for!
Yay! I love you, Dad!
I love you too, sweetheart! None of the past matters!
Oh, yeah, I seen that pudding billboard. It's the one that says CBS Outdoor Advertising on it.
Yeah, but right above that is like a big guy eating pudding.
I don't remember none of that. I just remember CBS Outdoor Advertising on the bottom and 3 pigeons sitting on top.
You're bad at looking at billboards.
We should go check it out right now.
Ordinarily, I'd say no, but that adult kickball league is coming in for drinks, so let's get out of here.
Guys, check it out. I've got flip-up shades on my flip-up shades.
Dude, you are the worst.
Hey, we're all the worst.
That's real pudding in there.
What? No, it isn't.
They wouldn't put real pudding on a billboard, Peter.
Do you have any idea how crippled you sound right now?
Peter, it's not real pudding. God, sometimes I just want to shake some sense into you.
Yeah, big talk for a guy who looks like a dad at a Dave Matthews concert. Everybody hates how you dress, right, Joe?
Sorry, I stay out of fashion debates. I've been burned one too many times. Hey, guys, notice anything different?
Yeah, Manetti's got a hot new look.
The whole thing, it just works.
Manetti!
Look, there's only one way to settle this. I am climbing that billboard to prove it's real pudding.
Moisturizer?
Sure.
Okay.
We getting on into the chappy season.
Peter, be careful up there!
Is this being careful enough, Joe?
Okay, all right.
Peter, are you okay?
All right, there's no pudding, but there is a kid up here.
Don't hold him like that.
Oh, my God, Peter! That's the Lost Nicholson kid! He's been missing for a week!
Oh, yeah. They arrested a custodian because of you.
Peter, stay put! I'll call this in and we'll get a crew out here to help you both down!
All right, but can you hurry it up? I got band practice later. I love playing the maracas. They're so fun. I wonder what's in them. Sand or rice, probably. Maybe it's little shells? Oh, no, what if it's bones? No, bones are too big. But baby bones aren't. No, nobody would kill a bunch of babies for maracas. How would you kill all those babies anyway? I'd probably put them in a tub. You could kill like 8 at a time that way. Plus, it softens them up so you can get the bones right out. Joe just had a baby. And I got a baby at home. I got a tub.
Peter, you seem off today. Are you thinking about killing infants again?
No. Now you gotta kill them, too.
Mikey, you're safe! Thank you so much for finding my boy!
Thank you for finding her boy. I'm the stepfather.
Peter Griffin, in recognition of your heroism in helping to rescue little Mikey Nicholson, I'd like to present you with this key to the city. Now, don't forget to water the plants every other day and change the cat's litter. I'll see you in 2 weeks. No parties!
Thank you, Mayor West. You know, some of you out there are calling me a hero. Others are calling me a hoagie. Those of you from Connecticut are calling me a grinder. I guess what I'm trying to say is, I'm not just pieces of meat between pieces of bread. I am a man who unintentionally saves kids.
Wow. 20 years on the force and no one's ever clapped for me. Except for that one sarcastic gay guy.
Great observation.
I know you mean the opposite of what you're saying.
Fact is, when I saved that boy, I wasn't thinking. I don't think. I just do. I wanted to see if a billboard had real pudding in it, so I climbed up there and came out a hero. It's just like Gandhi always said. Eat as much as you want and do whatever. And don't be afraid to hit each other.
Way to go, Dad!
Peter, that thing you said about not thinking and just doing stuff, did you mean that?
Sure I did, Joe. I never stop to think. That's why I've had ringworm 11 times. I will roll in anything.
You know what? You're right. And it's time I do the same thing. Hey, Chief, it's Swanson. I quit. Joe Swanson. I don't know if Ray Swanson's quitting. You'd have to ask him. Okay, you just called me Ray again. I just want to confirm that you understand that this is Joe. No, not see you tomorrow.
Joe, what are you doing? You can't quit your job.
Well, that's the other thing, Bonnie. You and I are done, too.
What?
I'm leaving you. Whoa! New Joe!
Wow. I can't remember the last time Joe shot his gun.
I know. That bullet's been rolling around in his junk drawer for years.
Hey, Ma, guess where I am? Yeah, can you hear it? Flying through the air. I don't know what he shot at. I guess I'll just have to find out when I land. No, don't put Terry on. You can just tell him. Hey, hi, Terry.
Oh, God.
What?
What? You know what?
I think it looks good.
You are just trying anything, aren't you? Just searching for an identity, man. And you think this is gonna be it, huh? Oh, God, whatever.
Peter, I'm worried about Joe. You know, not only did he quit his job, he's moved out and gotten his own apartment. Oh, I feel terrible for Bonnie and the kids.
Ah, they'll be fine. He'll bounce back, just like Humpty Dumpty did after his fall.
My God, it's a miracle. You were able to put me back together again.
Yeah, it was actually a pretty simple procedure. Maybe next time go straight to a medical professional and skip the horses and illiterate servants.
Well, that is the last time I drink and masturbate on top of a high wall.
Oh, wait, Quagmire, hold up. I got a great knock.
Oh, I gotta remember that.
Oh, hey, guys, how's it going?
Hey, buddy, how you doing? You okay? Everything okay? I'm talking like this because I'm being very careful not to upset you, and for some reason, this is the voice people use to do that.
Oh, I'm great. Come on in, check out the new pad.
Whoa, you got an air hockey table?
Yep. Wanted it, got it. That's the new Joe. And check this out. It's the gun that no-leg sprinter used to kill his girlfriend.
Oh, my God!
Anyone who's kind of fast gets a free pass from me.
What kind of person would want to buy that?
I'll tell you who. The kind of guy who's always got butterscotch candies for his friends.
Okay, now that's pretty cool.
I gotta be honest, Joe. We came over here because we were worried about you, but these candies tell me you're doing great.
I've never been better. I was living my life all wrong, but not anymore. No more thinking, just living.
Well, it seems like you made the right choice, Joe. I mean, I ain't seen anyone this happy since the invention of the penny farthing bicycle.
Eureka! Watch it go! Higher than you, faster than you, better than you! Everyone just stop inventing stuff now, because no one will ever top this! Oh no, keep rakes away! I expressly said no rakes allowed on the street when I am riding my futuristic machine! Oh! Children, this is progress! How can you turn a blind eye to progress? I expressly said no rakes.
Sup, ladies?
Oh, we're not ladies, you.
Hey, what's with the suitcase?
I got a surprise. What would you guys think of a road trip?
Oh, yeah! Hey, I'm in.
Awesome road trip! I love being super pumped for 15 minutes and then bored out of my mind for 8 hours.
Where are we going?
Well, I was thinking Niagara Falls.
Niagara Falls? Ain't that just for lovers?
Nah, it's for everybody. It's great to just stand there and let Mother Nature spray it all over your face.
Donna's big fat aunt is in town, so I can definitely go.
Man, I am filling these Gatorade bottles as fast as I'm drinking them.
Oh, sweet cows. Let's tip them over.
What? You want to tip over some cows?
Hell yeah. This is going to be so boss. I can't wait.
This is the hardest thing I've ever done in my life.
All right, cow. This is what you get for standing. That was awesome.
I want to kiss that cow, but I don't want it to be my idea.
Hey, Peter, you should kiss that cow.
All right, Peter, that was fortuitous, but play it cool.
Oh, Cleveland, I couldn't.
Okay, Quagmire, you should kiss that cow.
Sure, why not?
Ah!
Okay, they're sleeping. We're gonna have to party in the bathroom. Be careful around the really fat one. He's kinda like my boss.
What? Who's there? Joe, what the hell are you doing?
I went to a high school kegger party. Made a few new friends. This is Chrysalis, Ichabod, and Cancer.
Oh, I see three young men who could use the tickle monster.
That's a bad read, Pete.
Joe, it's 3 a.m. We're trying to get some sleep.
You guys are lame. We're gonna go smoke something called croak.
God, what the hell has gotten into Joe?
I don't know, Quagmire. Maybe you could ask the tickle monster.
No, here he goes.
No, he's gonna get you.
Great. Now I'm fully up.
Here we are, guys. Niagara Falls. We showed them. We showed them all.
Showed who? What the hell's he talking about?
I don't know. I stopped listening to him back at the drive-thru when he leaned out the window and ordered a fur burger. That's not funny. That's just nasty. Plus, there's people waiting behind you.
Wow. You know, when you see it up close, it really is incredible.
Yeah. Holy crap, it's beautiful.
In the future, I believe there will be water wars.
You know, Lois always dreamed about coming here, and now I know why. She was even saving money for it. You made it, Lois. You made it.
Didn't I tell you guys it's the most magnificent place in the world, and the greatest place to end it all? Goodbye, fellas.
Oh my God, Joe killed himself!
It's so weird that he argued over the price of breakfast this morning.
It makes no sense!
Damn it!
Joe? Joe, you're alive!
Are you hurt?
I'm not sure.
Well, hang in there, Joe. We'll get some help.
No! Just let me die!
Oh, no. Can't do that, Joe. We're friends. We look out for each other. I mean, you supported me that day I accidentally wore Lois's jeans.
Peter, you know you're wearing...
I know. I think there was a mix-up.
Oh, thank you, Jazzercise.
Don't worry, Joe. They're coming for you.
Yay, my backpack!
Hang in there, Joe. After they get that lady's hat, you're next.
Thank you. It's windy up here.
Joe, what the hell is wrong with you? Why would you try to kill yourself?
What do you think? I'm worthless.
But you've been so happy these last few days.
I've been manic. Do you think Andy Dick is happy?
I couldn't imagine, no.
Look, when I saw Peter become a hero, I guess it reminded me of all the things I can't do. I'm a cop who can't save anyone. I'm a husband in a legless marriage. My whole life is a joke. But somehow, as soon as I decided to kill myself, I actually felt free. Almost giddy. I can finally kiss this worthless life goodbye.
Let me get this straight. The whole point of bringing us to Niagara Falls was just to kill yourself?
Well, I'm sorry I tricked you guys into coming. I just wanted to spend my last week with my best pals.
Well, not for nothing, but you could have taken us all to Disney World and shot yourself in the room.
Come on, Joe, there's plenty of reasons to live. Like, you're handsome. You have a handsome face.
Well, he's got a good chin. I don't know about handsome.
Yeah, he's not handsome, but I will say this, he keeps a good lawn.
Yeah, some might say the second best lawn in the neighborhood.
Hey, where's Joe?
Joe, wait!
I stink at this.
Anywhere is fine.
Guys, this is unnecessary. Give me my chair back.
No, we can't trust you not to kill yourself.
Yeah, then you'd be the 10th friend who's killed himself in front of me.
Is that true?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, those two girls, and... Yeah, 10.
Look, you guys, what we really need to do is bring him back to Quahog where we can get him some help.
That's a good idea. We should just go home.
Yeah, I guess you're right. It's too bad we already bought those tickets for the Whirlpool Aero car.
Well, that's $16 we're not getting back.
Yeah, what a waste of money.
It is only a 10-minute ride, you know.
Okay, we'll do the Whirlpool Aero car and then take Joe back to Quahog.
What about the Whitewater Walk?
Okay, Whirlpool Aero car, then Whitewater Walk, then we bring Joe back.
Well, you can't do Niagara Falls without riding the Maid of the Mist.
Yeah, let's do everything.
Great!
And guys, remember, the pool towels go home with us. They got no way of accounting for those.
Well, this has just been one heck of a fun day.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, seeing the natural beauty of this place is actually making me feel much better. Hey, you mind opening that door? Get a little breeze in here?
Sure. Peter, no!
I don't regret it. The breeze is nice. Crap! I'm losing my grip!
You buy your jeans at Walmart?
No, somebody who lost theirs at the church did.
You wear lost and found jeans?
I waited the mandatory week.
Hang on, guys! Don't worry, I'm coming!
That thing he's on.
It's a chair with wheels.
He's an absolute dream.
Guys, keep swallowing water. We'll drink our way out of this.
You know, this is actually the first time I've ever touched Joe.
Don't worry, I gotcha!
Oh, thank God, Joe! I thought I was dead! I even pictured my own funeral!
Grandma got run over by a reindeer, walking home from our house Christmas Eve.
I don't know, Chris. I don't know why he wanted this, but... we're honoring your father's wishes.
I'm gonna miss my daddy.
Joe, that was amazing. You saved us.
Well, yeah. I guess I did. You know, I spent the whole time trying to kill myself, but it took seeing you guys almost die to realize that life really is worth living.
See, Joe, you're a hero too. And we wouldn't trade you for any friend in the world.
Thanks, Peter. I'm lucky to have you guys in my life. We're four friends having an adventure. Four friends.
Whoa. What's that song?
Nothing. I made it up.
Well, stop it. It's terrible.
I don't think so. It's catchy. We're four friends having an adventure.
Four friends having an adventure.
At Niagara Falls.
Listen
to
that.
Nice, yeah.
Wow, that was awesome.
Yeah, definitely. All right, okay, don't anyone sing anything else until we get home. We gotta record this.
Yeah, that'll be great.
I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world. Come on, Barbie, let's go party.
Peter, damn it, no. Wait, we gotta remember the other one. What was it, Joe?
It's gone.
That was kind of a weird trip, but I'm glad we went.
Yeah, I love Niagara Falls.
I was the only black man ever to go there. The tourists were taking pictures of me. One of them thought I was a bear.
Hey, guys.
Wow, Joe, you got your job back?
Sure did.
How'd you pull that off?
They always need more cops. Turns out not many people want to probably get shot for $24,000 a year.
And what about Bonnie? How you getting her back?
Well, I got a plan for that. I hired some guys to come to the house on Tuesday and assault her. And I'll come in and save her. And she'll be so grateful, she'll have to take me back.
Joe, today's Tuesday.
Well, poop.
Hi, it's me, Peter. You may be wondering what I'm doing in a library. Well, I actually drove my car into this rich guy's house, and he locked me in here until the police come. Don't believe me?
I don't know. I just locked him in the library. Seems like he's on something. He's got crazy eyes and keeps screaming, "I don't care."
I don't care! Anyway, I've got some time to kill before this room is filled with tear gas, so I thought, why not finally read some of the classics I never read in high school? Here's one right here. The Great Gatsby. A book by the only respected guy in the world named Scott.
It was my first summer staying at the shore, but I had a feeling that I, Nick the Situation Caraway, would fit right in. Hey, it's Nick from The Great Gatsby. I just checked in, and somebody left their teeth here. I don't know, it's just a set of teeth. I guess, men's? No, I'm not putting them anywhere. You come and get them. Ugh, the neighbors are having a party with loud jazz music. Well, at least annoyingly scatting over jazz hasn't been invented yet. Oh, that must have been invented today! Hey, whose party is this?
I'm not sure. Women aren't allowed to ask questions yet. So, what's your name?
Madam, you forget yourself. That's when I first laid eyes on him, Jay Gatsby. He was clearly playing with himself through his pocket, but I pretended not to see.
Hello, welcome to my party. Name's Gatsby. Good to meet you, old sport.
Yeah, just a wave is fine. I'm your new neighbor, Nick Caraway.
Oh, I hope we weren't too loud, old sport.
Yeah, this old sport thing, is this something you're trying out, or is this a keeper?
I just met you, so I want to tell you something very private. Let's go out to the dock. I come down here to think every night and gaze at that green light. It's where the love of my life lives, Daisy Buchanan.
I hate to break it to you, but that light you've been looking at is a gay gym called the Pump House. I only know that because I saw a coupon that came with my rental. Anyway, Daisy's house is over there. She's my cousin.
Daisy's your cousin?
Yeah, a lot of weird coincidences for an American classic, huh?
What? I have to see her.
Well, I can set that up. Only thing is, she's married.
Yeah, and I hear her husband's a real heel.
Whoa, language! But yeah, I'll set it up. Tea tomorrow at my house, 2 p.m.
Great. She's gonna be there, right?
Yeah, why wouldn't she be there?
I don't know, I'm just getting a funny vibe from you.
You ask me down to the docks alone, and you're getting a funny vibe from me?
Wow, what an ugly little house.
Oh yeah, it's not that palace of domestic abuse you live in.
What's up?
Oh my god, is it really you?
Oh, I've missed you, Daisy. You're as beautiful as ever. You know what else is beautiful? My bank account. Boom, rich guy.
You're rich now? Oh my god, I love that.
I know, right? Come on, I'll show you my place.
Oh, you're leaving? But I made all these deviled eggs.
You made?
You know what I meant.
Yeah, you made them. Great job.
You know, one of the best parts of having an enormous mansion is being able to come out here and get some fresh air. You know, sometimes I just want to jump off this balcony and into that pool down there.
So do it.
Yeah, I know, right? Do it.
Yeah, do it.
I know, I totally should, right? Here I go. One, two, three. Whoa! Can you imagine?
Yeah, I can't imagine. It would be fun. You should do it.
If only it were that easy, right?
It is. It looks deep enough. It's your pool. It's your house. You can do whatever you want.
I know, right? Oh, you know what? I can't right now. My pool guy's cleaning it.
Are you going to bone her?
This is amazing. I've never seen so many shirts. Do you have enough to, you know, throw?
Yeah, you know, they're actually kind of expensive. Oh, there she goes.
Shirt! 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 Shirt!
Okay, five is good. Five is probably good.
Shirt! Shirt!
Were you this crazy when we dated before?
Gatsby, is it? I've been hearing about your vast newly acquired wealth and your attentions to my wife. So, I thought I would have you over to my equally large and fancy but imperceptibly more classy mansion for an awkward dinner.
And Nick, have you met Jordan? She plays golf and is what kids will someday call a duff.
Hey, yeah. Nice tam o' shanter.
I'll drink your finger bowl if you don't want it.
In the book, I actually go on a few dates with Jordan. We're gonna skip all that.
Anyway, like I was saying, you're a trash because you earned your money a little bit more recently than me.
What are you getting at?
I'm saying I invited you over and sat you next to my wife to say, stay away from my wife. You know what we should do? Let's all drunk drive into Manhattan and get a hotel room and have the same conversation we're having here. I'm starting to think this isn't a very good book. I'd like to add another bit of pointless confusion that will make sense later. Let's everyone drive somebody else's car.
Someone can take my coupe.
I'm riding with Gatsby. I don't care which car.
I'll take someone in Daisy's car.
I don't think Daisy said you could drive her car.
Tom, why don't you take Jay's car?
Who's Jay?
Gatsby.
Okay, I have never heard anyone call him that.
Look, if you're in your own car, you're in the wrong car.
All right, you guys get gas. I gotta talk to this random mechanic's horny wife about some business. Wilson, gonna need to fill her up. Wilson's wife, fill her up. Get it? Yeah.
I don't know what they do up there, but they sure do listen to Def Leppard pretty loud.
So, have you seen any good movies lately?
We just saw A Woman Tied to Railroad Tracks 5. Pretty similar to 4.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Well, it looks like you guys are getting a head start on the depression here.
Thanks for stopping by, Mr. Buchanan.
Yeah, sure. Don't tell anyone how bad I look naked. Have fun raising my bastard. All right, let's head out. Wait, but first, I want to see if we're in the funny horn era. Aha, we are! All right, Gatsby, you think you're so hot? Let me show you how a classy guy does classy stuff. Hello, room service. I'd like a bottle of your second most expensive champagne.
And I'd like your most expensive bottle.
Wow, walked right into that one. Okay, fine. Well, then let's see who has highest socks. Yeah!
Whatever, Tom. None of that matters. Daisy's in love with me. In fact, she's never loved you.
Oh, is that so? Well, I hear Gatsby didn't even fight in World War I.
Wait, why is he calling it that? Is there gonna be another big war?
I'm sorry, Tom.
That's right. I'm in love with Daisy and she loves me, old sport.
Would anyone like a deviled egg from a tea I had several days ago?
Well, that was awful, but I sure do enjoy driving your car instead of you driving it, even though we came in a different car.
Drunk. Don't forget, drunk. You're drunk driving my car.
Gas and sandwiches. Get your gas and sandwiches.
Oh, that must be Tom since I saw him in that car earlier. Tom! Tom, it's me!
Oh, no! Myrtle! Where will I ever find another woman with a hotter name than Myrtle?
All right, Poole, do your thing.
You hungover?
A little bit, yeah. Okay, we're sort of racing to the end here. And with that, I shall step slightly out of range.
All right, I'm just gonna take a quick swim.
Oh my God, where are the stairs? There's no stairs! I'm never gonna make it!
You were standing earlier in the day next to the car that hit my wife.
I would soon return to New York a changed man, because for me, that will always be the summer that I finally put my head underwater.
I did it! I did it!
Ah, I wish somebody had seen that.
Hi, me again. I'm not in that guy's library anymore. I snuck up to the attic just before the cops busted in. They're down there now. Look. Only problem is, I really want to get to that trunk of costumes in the corner. On the one hand, I don't want to give away my location. On the other hand, there might be a pirate hat. No pirate hat, but I'll make it work.
Arr, I'm a chef aboard a pirate ship. Now, who be wanting pancakes?
I think I hear something in the attic.
Oh, crap. While I figure out my options, here's Huckleberry Finn.
Hey, Huckleberry Finn.
Hi, Tom Sawyer. You're Tom, I'm Huck. Everybody good? Yep. All right, let's do this.
Huckleberry Finn, you get inside this house this minute. It's Tuesday morning. It's time for church.
Oh, Widow Douglas, I already been to church 3 times today. I want to stay home and play Angry Birds. This is addictive.
Hey, I'm your abusive dad, and I've been drinking all day from this here jug.
Oh, my God, is that a jug full of porn? Hey, Widow Douglas, I want to live with my dad.
Shut your hole. Now come on, I need to use your pee. I'm taking a wagon test in the morning.
I wish you wouldn't drink so much.
Stop counting my drinks. Now get over here so I can whip you.
Ow! Crap! No!
Yeah, that's right, bitch. Now it's your turn.
Jeez, this is worse than the Widow Douglas's house. I gotta get out of here. I know. I'll fake my own death. I just need enough blood to make it look real.
Hey there, you must be Huck. Great to finally meet you. I hope you like it here.
I'm gonna stab you for your blood.
Oh, come on. I just got shot in the pool in the last one.
Ah! I can't remember why I needed the blood.
Lord, I'm gonna tell you, being a slave is a much worse job than the temp agency made it sound. You gonna eat all that possum?
I am. My name's Huck Finn. What's half of your name?
Jim. Nice to meet you. I'm a runaway slave.
I'm running away because people want me to wear shoes and comb my hair. So I guess we got the exact same problem. Hey, what's that sound?
Oh, no. It sounds like a waterfall! Hold on! We died. So wait, we didn't die?
I don't know. It's all just jokes. Ah, did you see that?
What?
I just skipped that rock 6 times. That's a once-in-a-lifetime skip.
That's nice.
You don't believe me, do you?
I believe we've been out here a long time, and a man's mind begins to play tricks on him.
It happened for real! I can't believe you didn't see it!
Of course I saw it. Most amazing damn thing I ever did witness. But I wasn't gonna tell Huck, because he claimed he didn't see me hook shot that apple core into the garbage from way far away.
Hello, friends!
Why are you so friendly? You con man?
No, we're businessmen. We're fake selling the Brooklyn Bridge.
Don't say fake selling.
We're real selling the Brooklyn Bridge.
Stop qualifying the selling. We're just selling the Brooklyn Bridge.
I'll buy it.
Hold on now, Huck. These fellas are con men. Push off, you grifters. We don't want to ever see you again.
Fine, we're going. It's a river. We can't control how fast it goes. We can barely steer.
Sorry.
Hey, what if it's spelled with an A at the end of it? Is that okay? Jim? 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 Jim?
If you're looking for a gym, ye old pump house is that way. Can't miss it. Green light on a dock.
Tom Sawyer? What are you doing so far from home?
Rush is playing here tonight. They wrote a song about me.
Oh. Well, I'm looking for my friend, Jim.
Huck, great news. I'm free.
You are? That's awesome! When did that happen?
It's just being revealed now, but it happened hundreds of pages ago.
Oh. Huh. Weird. So, what's left to do?
I'll tell you what. Rush concert!
Monday warrior, mean stride. Today's Tom Sawyer, mean stride.
Hey, I'm Mark Twain. Pretty cool book, huh?
Well, while I'm being booked and processed downtown, we have time for one more classic of American literature. This one's about idiots choking rodents. I give you Of Mice and Men.
Read him his rights.
You know what? I'd like to read him myself. Chapter 1, Eat My Ass, Pigs. Ah, the bones in my nose!
Wow, I remember when this used to be all orange groves.
It's currently all orange groves.
Tell me again about our dream, George.
All right, all right. We're going to open a bed and breakfast in the country. And we won't be afraid to let our guests know that we are Steelers fans in this house.
What about the rabbits?
Yeah, we'll have rabbits too. But we'll also have a sign in the front that says Steelers fan parking only. And sometimes we'll give our guests a fake hard time. Like if they're Jets fans, we'll be all like, okay, I hope you don't get towed. But obviously, you know, of course, we're not going to tow them.
Hey,
Hey there, strangers. Welcome to Phelps Ranch. People call me Slim.
Ironically, I assume. Listen, we're looking for field work, if you need any extra hands.
Well, three of our guys did just get squished, so we just might. Come on in. So, have you done this kind of work before?
Have we pulled an object off a plant and placed it in a burlap bag? Yes, I think we understand the nuances of this profession.
Good, good. And how about you? Tell me about yourself.
I like to kill animals and then a lady.
I got a good feeling about you guys. All right, you guys are doing great. Hey, listen, my dog just had puppies, and I thought, since you're covered with feces and I barely know you, I'd give you a delicate Snow White newborn puppy.
Okay, just don't give me the dead eyes over there, because I've already been killed twice in the other two stories, and I don't want...
Puppy!
Ah, fuck!
This puppy doesn't work.
Well, well, well.
As you can tell by the well, 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 he's the bad guy.
Looks like we got us some new employees.
That's right, Curly. I hired him this morning.
Well, tell him to get out. This is where I practice my karate, because I'm a dick.
I understand you like to pick fruit. You ever pick something bruised and pear-shaped?
Fruit has seeds you can poo out!
Hey, Hodor, stop coming on to my slutty wife!
Look, I can tell by the fact that you wear a single Vaseline-filled leather glove that you're a reasonable man, so let's all take a deep breath and calm down.
Now, karate chop! Oh, damn it!
I tucked my jeans into my boots!
I'll get you, you stupid giant moron!
Not great timing, I know, but can I leave early for a dentist appointment? So, I should be home by 10. It's just this piano bar slash cabaret place called Tinkles. Rory told me about it.
Who's Rory?
You remember him. The field hand who gave me a shoulder ride back to the house? That was Rory. Anyway, it sounds like it's just a hoot.
Wow, maybe you'll meet a pretty lady to get married to there.
Yeah, well, that's the idea.
While you're gone, can I touch myself?
Again, you don't have to schedule that with me. But remember, if there's any trouble, we meet by the big tree on the edge of town.
Everything in my head is screaming.
All right then, I am off.
I'm just saying, Mr. Horse, if you wear a pair of sunglasses, you will get laughs. Well, then you and I, sir, will simply have to agree to disagree.
Well, hello there, if it isn't the sexy imbecile.
Oh, hi. Sorry about what I did to your husband earlier.
Yes, that was quite a hand job you did on him. You know, I'm not so bad at those myself.
I'm not gonna lie to you. You're wasting your double entendres on me.
I want you to destroy me.
Okay.
Get those peepers, jeepers, creepers. Where'd you get those eyes?
Thank you, thank you. Oh, I just love a song that explains what it just said. All right, evidently I have to go to the big tree on the edge of town to take care of something. This shouldn't take too long. Do not take my songs off the list.
I'm sorry, George. I didn't mean to kill the girl, and now the whole town's gonna hang me by a rope.
Oh, I would never let that happen.
Thanks. Tell me about the rabbits, George.
Yeah, sure thing. But while I do that, why don't you face away from me and count the stars?
Okay.
All right, so the B&B will have a rack of single-gear bikes for every guest. And yes, next to that, of course, is going to be the big giant rabbit hutch. Bye-bye, Lenny. Good night, kids. Good luck with those book reports. Hey, Brian, have you seen the remote? I want to watch the Weather Channel. There are tornadoes in the Midwest, and I like watching poor people scramble to save what little they have.
I don't know where the remote is.
All right, I'll find it myself.
Oh, my God, my old harmonica!
I'm going to play this really loud tonight to get back at our Armenian neighbors.
Hey! Hey, looks like a fun party. Hey, listen, it's 2 a.m. When is your 5-year-old going to go to sleep?
Soon, very soon. You want weird food wrapped in weird leaves?
Yeah, look, I'm guessing there's some kind of soccer match from your home country going on, and I get that, I do, but some of us are trying to sleep, and I could almost deal with the noise, but it's the cologne. All right, I can smell it in my bed, and I live 2 houses from here. That's how powerful it is. Okay? That's how powerful it is.
You like it?
Yeah, I kind of like it. Okay, so I know you're a harmonica, but right now you're a 40-year-old woman with a good body in a hotel pool.
Hey, everybody, look at me!
I work out 7 days a week for these 5 minutes. Your attention is going to keep me from swallowing a bottle of pills.
Hey, everyone. I made brownies.
I better hurry up. I'm going to miss the show.
What did I do? What did I do?
I love Brownie Day.
Hey, so, I'm digging a hole under the fence in the backyard.
Brian, you have a car. You don't have to escape.
Just don't say anything, okay?
Oh, you know what? Hang on. I left my harmonica in the tub.
I think Peter's in there taking a bath.
Yeah, son of a bitch! What the hell did I just sit on?
Where is it? Where's my harmonica? It's not here!
Peter, have you seen Stewie's harmonica? It was in the tub.
Oh, my God. It was in the tub, and now it's in my butt! No!
Stewie, Daddy needs your tiny hands for a very special project.
Well, good heavens, that's something, isn't it? By the way, Mr. Griffin, regarding your x-rays, we're making a coffee table book. Can you sign this release, please?
Okay, but first, can we address my husband's situation?
Well, the harmonica's up there pretty good. Unfortunately, removing it would require a very expensive surgery that's not covered by your TGI Fridays gift card.
What was that?
I don't know. But suddenly it smells like John Popper in here.
That was me! I got musical farts! Holy crap, this is awesome! I will not allow this opportunity to go to waste. Hey, Lois, how was your day?
Terrible. I accidentally backed over a kid in the grocery store parking lot. Peter, I'm serious. I ran right over the soft part of the face. I had to run away. I ditched the car and jumped on a passing train. I was so scared, I didn't get off until I was in the South. What'd you do today?
I pushed a boy behind your car so I could do all this harmonica stuff. All right, Chris. Meg loves to listen to music when she sleeps. Let's see how she likes this.
Dad, I don't think that's how it works.
This had nothing to do with the harmonica.
Everybody, brace yourselves, because I have got big news. I have been selected to be a contestant on America's Got Talent, and they're gonna fly us all to America for the show.
What? Oh, my God!
Finally, we're making the dreams come true in America!
I am gonna make this family proud. And not just you guys, but that old painting of my ancestor in the attic. I did it! I'm gonna be on TV!
Did you kill the others?
I shan't!
You must.
I'm gonna go talk to the statue in the basement.
Did you kill the painting?
This place is a nut house.
Yo, welcome back to America's Got Talent. Let's welcome our next performer, here to play the harmonica, Peter Griffin.
Hi.
So, where are you from, Peter?
I'm from Quahog, Rhode Island.
Woohoo! Quahog!
That's my family. My wife daytime drinks on vacation.
Okay, Peter, let's hear what you've got.
Wow, he's nailing it.
I know, shut up.
Well, there goes my music career. Wonder if I can get my old job back, painting kids' faces at birthday parties. There you go, Timmy.
Sir, you're gonna have to leave. You're just drawing penises with a Sharpie on children's faces.
I don't know how to draw a cat.
Hi, I'm Amanda.
I'm Chris. You look nice, so I'll blow my burps the other way.
You're funny.
Oh, thanks. Usually people just find me awkward. I have a hard time with small talk.
Did you find everything you were looking for?
Eh, I did all right for a guy who just had his first homosexual experience with his guitar teacher.
All right, guys, keep an eye out for our stuff. I got tired of not being able to find my bag, so I tied a vaguely Hanna-Barbera-looking character to it.
This trip was impossible.
There we go.
I really enjoyed sitting next to you on the plane, Chris.
Me too. I'm sorry I screamed when that guy from India got up to stretch.
Look, I'm having brunch tomorrow with my grandparents at the Barrington Country Club. Maybe your family could join us.
Okay, that sounds like fun.
Oh my God, Chris is dating a Barrington.
Who are the Barringtons?
They're the richest family in all of Rhode Island. I must notify Gossip Girl. Pass this along to Gossip Girl. It's me. I'm Gossip Girl.
I still can't believe Chris is dating a Barrington. They own this whole club.
Yeah, look at all this luxury. It's like being in a gay guy's dream.
Enjoying the view?
It's glorious, Edwin. Would you like another salad bowl of chocolate-covered oysters? Is that gay enough?
And then some. This has been the gayest vacation I've ever had.
I love smelling me on your breath.
Peter, what are you doing here? You're not a member. And that means me and the other jocks get to throw you in the pool. Hey, Banks, Duffy, get over here. This guy's going for a swim. Grab him. All right, you're kind of heavy, so we're going to pee on you. Not happening. All right, we'll just spit on you. Nothing we have works.
Daddy, we're here to have brunch with the Barringtons.
The Barringtons? How is that possible? That family is the pinnacle of high society. They haven't worked in 8 generations. All the kids have drug problems. Most of them have OD'd.
That's terrible.
Well, not all kids make it, Lois. Just ask the Sugar Smacks Frog.
I'm sorry. I'm afraid you've lost 2 more. What should we do about the graves?
Dig 'em.
You look really handsome today, Chris.
Thanks, Amanda.
Hey, Chris, say it.
I use Stuart Griffin Facial Cleanser. Try some.
Give her the website.
StewieGriffinFacial.com.
No, that's something else. It's StewieGriffinFacialCleanser.com.
Hey, listen, Mr. Barrington, your granddaughter ain't no tease, right? Because Chris really wants to get in there.
Oh, you're a funny guy, Griffin. I like that.
Oh, well, you should hear my prank phone calls. Hey, is your refrigerator running?
Yes, it is. Are your doors unlocked?
What? Why? I don't know. They all kind of look the same.
What do you mean they all look the same?
Hey, there's all my favorite people.
Oh, no, not this suck-up.
Ah, what are we talking about? Black people? Mexicans? Jews? So good to see you, Barrington.
Hey, where are we going today, Reginald? Huh? Where are we going today? You and me as pals, ain't we, Reginald?
Peter Schmidt, settle down. I was having a nice conversation with Peter. Peter, why don't you tell me more about your job? You said you like to drink at work?
I do.
Oh, me too. Me too. I'll drink anything. Even that hollandaise sauce. Give me that.
Hey, Brian. Meg's Benedict.
Ah-ha-ha-ha.
Oh, God. Stop. Stop. I'm sorry, man. I even said it. I'm sorry. It was a mistake. I'm sorry I said it.
Peter, why don't you and I grab some air, huh?
Daddy, you're making a fool out of yourself. Why are you acting like this?
Look, I've been trying to get into Reginald Barrington's inner circle for years. They've been the most elite family in this country ever since it was founded. They were the ones who invented the buckle on the hat. Hey, I like your zipper hat.
I like your zipper hat.
Morning, fellas.
Oh, that's gonna be a game changer.
Do you hunt, Peter?
Well, I went to 3 stores to find this shirt.
Peter, you've got moxie. I like that.
Hey, I've got moxie, too. Watch this. Carmen Miranda, Carmen Miranda. Was she a singer? Was she a dancer? Nobody knows. They just remember the fruit.
Peter Schmidt, you imbecile. You think that's funny? Wasting fruit? There are people dying in hilarious places. That is it. You are officially kicked out of this club.
What?
Griffin, we just had an opening. Congratulations. You are now a member.
Oh, my God, really? And to think yesterday I was just a guy at home eating catnip.
Excuse me, Mr. Peterschmidt, but you're no longer a member at this club.
Don't worry, he's my guest.
Now look, Peter, just because you're a member now and I'm your guest, that doesn't mean things are gonna change between us, right?
No, of course not. Excuse me a moment, Carter.
Hey, guys, I just bumped into Carter Peterschmidt outside. What a loser, huh? Okay, when he wasn't looking, I stuck a springy snake in his wallet.
What?
Ah! And I switched out one of his eyeballs for a gag exploding eyeball.
What? That's impossible.
Ah! And then I paid a couple of Mexicans to run over him with their car. I hope they don't just take the money and skip town. Okay, you ready for some polo?
All right, this is more like it. Where's Buttercup?
Oh, only members can ride Buttercup. Guests have to ride Topsy the Roid Rage Horse. Now, whatever you do, don't say his trigger word.
What?
Ah, that's his trigger word! Ah! Ah, 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 ah! Don't yell! His parents were slaughtered by yellers! Just submit!
I am submitting! It's getting worse!
No, I mean really submit!
Okay, okay!
Oh my God, I meant say you're sorry, not take off your pants! Carter, what are you doing? Oh my God! And now that I've made you aware of the misunderstanding, you're still continuing with it! Oh my God! And I'm still watching! What's wrong with me? Oh my God!
We now return to Game of Thrones on BET.
I got a big-ass coat, chair to sit in, childish cup of wine, and a midget. But I ain't going out there with all them monsters out there!
Daddy, what happened to you?
I can't live without the country club. You did this, Peter. This is all your fault.
I like your hair.
Well, Daddy, you've been treating Peter like dirt for years.
It's choppier. It's more texturized. Did you go to the Asian guy with the one name?
Well, now that you know how it feels, maybe you want to give him an apology.
You went to Taki, didn't you?
Look, Peter, I'm sorry for the way I treated you, but is there anything you can do to get me back in the club?
Well, I suppose I could talk to Barrington.
Really? Oh, Peter, you don't know what this means to me. Oh, you know, I was so desperate there for a while, I even tried a Jewish club.
You don't want to get involved with them religious groups. They believe in all kinds of weird stuff.
If I believe in Jesus hard enough, I will not die.
If I believe in Snake Jesus hard enough, he will die.
If I believe in Tree Jesus hard enough, both of them will die.
Yay! Thank you, Tree Jesus!
Hey, Mr. Barrington.
Oh, hello, Peter. I'm so glad you're here. We're shooting bald guys under 5'7 today.
Hey, there's the guy who denied my health insurance claim.
Sir, your nipples are fine. You don't need to reconstruct them.
I want Hershey Kiss nipples, and I want you to pay for them. Look, Mr. B, if it's okay with you, I'd like to give my membership back to Carter.
I'm sorry, Peter, but I just don't think Pewterschmidt is country club material. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm about to shoot Michael Stipe.
Is that him in the corner?
Yes, that is him in the corner.
Is that him in the spotlight?
Would you... Oh, damn it, now he got away.
Oh, no. I said too much.
I want you out of here.
Look, Mr. Barrington, he's my father-in-law. So if he goes, I go.
Fine, I don't care. Your lowbrow antics no longer amuse me, Griffin. You're both out of the club.
Well, I guess that's it then.
Oh, there is one more thing, actually. Can you talk to that angry little boy down by the riverbank?
Yeah, sure. Hey, what's eating you?
Grown-ups.
Yeah, grown-ups suck.
Why do they get to make all the rules?
I know it seems unfair. But hey, there ain't no rules in a tickle fight.
Stop! That tickles! Hey, Timmy, there you are!
Who the f*** are you? Get away from our son!
But Mr. Barrington told me to...
Who's Mr. Barrington?
From the club.
What club? You're in a lot of trouble, mister.
Yeah! I'm sorry I got us both kicked out, Carter. I was just trying to help you out.
Mr. Barrington told me I couldn't see Amanda anymore. We never even got a chance to have sex. Everyone knows rich, waspy girls are the best at it.
I'm really gonna miss that club. You know what part I like the most? Walking around the locker room naked and offering people sections of a tiny clementine.
Clementine?
Oh, thank you.
Clementine?
None for me, thanks.
Clementine?
Yes, thank you.
Clementine?
Yeah, I'll have one.
Ooh, softly.
Sorry. Yes, I'll have one.
There you go. God, it's good to be old and nude.
Look, Carter, you can't be that surprised. I mean, it's just human nature to suck up to the people above you, crap on those beneath you, and undercut your equals.
Well, then we've just got to figure out a way to make you fancy it in Barrington, so he's got to suck up to you.
I don't know, Peter. That'd be pretty tough to pull off.
We just got to be bold, like those backwards knee birds.
Oh, what are you looking at? Oh, you coming for me? Nope. Nope, I'll just take a big backward knee step in the opposite direction. Yeah. Yeah, you think I'm afraid of you? I slept on your back last night, you...
Yes, I'll have the filet mignon, and they can start the sunset now.
Someone important must be arriving, because they're making a big entrance.
Announcing the arrival of his and his majesty, the exceedingly wealthy and very important Viscount James Earl Tennis Racket and Duke of Lacrosse team.
Hello, I'm Reginald Barrington. Where are you fine gentlemen from?
We are European, from the United Colors of Benetton.
But you don't sound like you're from Europe.
Is that so? Well, perhaps I should take my thong elsewhere.
Let's not be hasty, Your Majesty. Won't you please join me as my personal guest in the Barrington Room?
The Barrington Room? Peter, that's the most exclusive room in all of New England.
Yeah, here it's even harder to get in there than the University of Arizona.
Well, it's beating. Welcome to the Wildcats.
This is the Barrington Room. Have a seat in the deepest, most luxurious leather chair in the world.
Oh, that's nice.
Sir, may I offer you a shoe drink?
Why, yes, that'd be lovely. Ah, the finer things.
So, what brings you gentlemen to town?
We're here on business. In fact, we just came from a meeting with the venerable Carter Pewterschmidt. Outstanding man.
Really? Yeah, well, he used to be a member here, but he was very annoying.
Oh, my, that's surprising. I've heard he has quite the blue blood pedigree. You know, he got a piece of Jackie Kennedy before she was defiled by that hairy olive eater.
Yeah, and he once made me a grilled cheese sandwich after this.
Well, I wasn't sure about Pewterschmidt, but after hearing you gentlemen talk, maybe I could give him another chance.
Really?
Oh, wow, that's great news, Carter. You're back in. Hey, let's get a couple of girls and have seventh grade in the same room makeouts.
Carter? Wait a minute. You're not Duke of Lacrosse team, and you're not Viscount James Earl Tennis Racket. Security, come throw these frauds out of my club.
Damn it, Peter, you blew it!
Yay!
I knew I couldn't depend on you! You're not worthy to lick my designer's shoes, you fat lowlife slob!
But Carter, please!
Here, skip this rope and do a lively schoolgirl chant.
But Carter, I don't know any city girl rhymes.
Do it!
Lettuce, carrots, peppers, and peas. Your mother says you gotta have these.
Now do it double time with new vegetables.
Cabbage, taters, spinach, and peas.
You already said peas.
I don't know any more vegetables.
Wait a second. Hang on there. The way you abused that man just now, the way you treated your lesser, I underestimated you, Pewterschmidt. I thought you were just some suck-up loser, but you have shown me that you've got the mettle to be one of us. You are back in the club.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Barrington.
Yes. Now, I believe there is just one last piece of unfinished business to take care of here.
I'm sorry, but the Viscount James Earl Tennis Racket and Duke of Lacrosse team already arrived 2 hours ago.
But that's impossible!
Peter, I'm sorry you've got to give up the country club life.
No, that's okay, Lois. Because, you know, I gotta say, I don't think those rich guys have it all that great. Too much stress. You know, you give me the choice, I'll choose our life any day of the week.
Me too, Peter. Can I have $50 to get my hair cut?
Absolutely not. That's a waste of money. I will cut it myself. You look like garbage. What happened?
We now return to Jeremy Piven as the Incredible Hulk.
You wouldn't like me when I'm angry.
I don't like you now.
Brian, I need the TV.
Why is Rupert wearing a top hat?
Because, Brian, tonight we sup on the finest feast of the television season. It is the season finale of the Cadwalladers of Essex.
The what?
The Cadwalladers of Essex. It's groundbreaking. It's a British show about a wealthy family dealing with slight change.
Oh, I thought that got cancelled.
No, that was the Cadogans of Aubrey Mews.
Is that the one where even the children have mutton chops?
No, that's the Whittakers of Edgerton Crescent.
All these shows sound the same. Who's in this one?
Penelope Westworth Harrington.
Who's that?
Penelope Westworth Harrington? Oh, come on! From the Roysters of Pumbridge on Thames? Her uncle was steward to the Queen's Privy. She got ploughed on a pile of hay in Game of Thrones.
Oh, yeah. She's hot.
You're an idiot. Like a guy who cheats on his right hand with his left hand.
I want to stay, but I just got called back into the office. What do you want from me? I'm sorry, all right? Just get off my back. I'm out of here. God, it took me forever to get away. Oh, my God! No! What have you done? Wait! Stop! No, please! I'm begging you!
Oh, it's starting! I'm gonna live tweet the show and ruin it for everyone in other time zones.
I would like to learn to bathe myself.
Everything I've ever heard is vexing.
Oh, this is the fastest moving episode I've ever seen! Oh, wouldn't it be marvelous to be a part of a family like that?
Ah, I found that chick in the hay.
Unga bunga, unga bunga, unga bunga!
What is that? What's happening?
Unga Bunga! Unga Bunga! Unga Bunga!
Peter, what are you doing?
Playing Unga Bunga! It's the championship!
Go away! This is why Zillow estimates our house at $4.
What the hell is Unga Bunga?
Two guys run at each other with mattresses and, that's kind of it.
Stop explaining it to the dog! Let's do this! Yeah!
Stop it! I'm trying to watch my program!
Well, Chris, look, Mom's naked!
Where?
You creep.
No!
Peter, what's going on in...
Anger Bunga!
You imbeciles! You ruined my night! I ask for one thing in this house!
Stewie, just watch your show upstairs.
I don't want to watch it upstairs on the small TV. I want to watch it downstairs on the big TV. I want to watch my show!
Oh, no. Stewie's having a tantrum. Come here, sweetie. Ow! Screw you, you little turd!
What's all that noise? Oh, do you want a hug from your big sister?
Ow! You've earned yourself a timeout, young man. Now you stay in here until you can behave.
I hate you. You always ruin everything. God, it's a family of idiots. I wish I was never born. Not tonight, Rupert. I'm much too upset.
Knock, knock. Stewie? Yeah, I just wanted to check on how you're doing, buddy. You put on quite a show last night.
I am done with this family. They don't deserve me. They're all just...
Oh, you dick. You just came in to charge your phone.
Sorry, Peter's using all the outlets.
Toast house.
Whatever. I'm gonna be out of this place soon anyway.
What, are you running away from home?
Better.
What the hell? You rebuilt your time machine? I thought you swore off time travel because you couldn't stop yourself from altering the past.
Look, Brian, I need this machine to alter the past for the better.
What do you mean?
I loathe this family. Being born into it was clearly some sort of cosmic mistake, so I'm going back in time to prevent that mistake. I'm going to break up Lois and the Fat Man before they can conceive me.
Stewie, it's one TV show. You're overreacting.
It's not just the TV show, Brian. I'm tired of living with morons. Remember when I tried to open that lemonade stand with Chris? All right, that'll be 10 cents. Chris, pour the man his lemonade.
I can't! The lemonade tricked me and got away!
Lemons are God's children!
And the Fat Man won't even let me celebrate a proper birthday!
Happy birthday, Stewie! And here's your equal attention cake, Peter.
Yay!
Oh, come on!
Yay, double wishes! One. Two.
And Meg's the biggest pig of all!
Great, the string broke again.
Hey there, tiny hands.
Look, Stewie, I know you're angry about last night, but you're talking about erasing your existence. That's crazy.
Whose ringtone is Barracuda?
Oh, God, that's Frumpy Ann. Frumpy Ann does everything. Look, I gotta get this call, but don't do anything stupid.
Yo, girl, how you living?
Ugh.
All right, Rupert, prepare to time travel. Oh, and by the way, thanks for asking me if I wanted something from Subway, too. Where am I? This looks like my room, but something's off. Oh, that's right, this isn't my room yet. I wonder what they're using it for. Oh my God, he had a public access show? Live from the shores of Rhode Island, it's the fatty who drives you batty, Peter Griffin!
Hey, douchebags, we got a great show for you tonight. Karen Washington from the Rhode Island Zoo and some rejected toys you're not gonna believe. So stick around or...
I'll come to your house and murder you!
I wonder what else is different.
Lucky there's a man who has to give a kangaroo all the things that make us
la la la!
She's camel-toeing the hell out of that leotard. All right, Rupert, time to break up Lois and the Fat Man before they can conceive me by pressing butts together. Well, you don't know either!
Hey, Lois, I drawed you a picture. It's me and you on the space moon, because I would love you anywhere.
Oh, Peter, I'd love you anywhere, too.
Wow, Peter and Lois were really in love before I was born.
And this is me getting you from behind, because in space, no one can hear you scream.
Oh, Peter!
Breaking them up may prove to be more difficult than I thought. Though I've faced bigger challenges before, like when I had to ride that bike in the Muppet movie. That's right. Stewie Longlegs just blew your mind. All right, Rupert, now to break up my parents. The number one thing couples fight about is money. So I've maxed out Lois's credit card on vibrating marital aids.
Peter, there's an open box in the kitchen addressed to me with nothing inside.
Yeah, when I opened it up, it was empty.
Well, that's very strange, because it looked large enough to hold many items.
It's the mailman. I'll get it.
No, me, I'll get it.
Maybe I had more in common with this family than I thought.
Oh, my God, Peter. What happened to your hair?
I don't know. I'm bald. You did this. What the hell's the matter with you?
I didn't do it, but you look really cool.
I do?
Yeah, you look like you could be a celebrity.
Hey, can I get your autograph?
Oh, of course. Here you go.
They think I'm Bruce Willis.
That was the monster from Goonies.
None of my attempts to break them up has worked thus far, so I had to up our game.
Lois, what the hell did you do? I just got a note from Goodwill thanking me for donating all my porn.
What? I'm sick and tired of you blaming me for things I didn't do. And I've got a bone to pick with you. I don't appreciate how you spray-painted Vile Woman on the bedroom wall.
That wasn't me. Must have been one of the kids.
That's ridiculous, Peter. Chris can't write, and we don't allow Meg upstairs.
Well, you know something? I'm starting to think whoever wrote that is right.
Well, maybe I don't want to live with someone who doesn't respect me.
Well, and maybe I should just leave.
Then where are you gonna go? You got nothing else and nobody else.
And now for the closer.
I might go west.
My God, I've done it, Rupert! They've broken up! Look! It's working! I'm fading away! Well, Rupert, this means you and I will never have met. So, I've got to tell you one thing. You know that song I wrote you for Valentine's Day? It's an Eric Carmen song. I completely ripped it off. Ah, now I feel better. What the devil? What's going on? Where am I?
It's a boy.
I'm in a hospital. My soul must have found another carrier. I've been reborn.
Welcome to the world, baby chap.
I'm British? All right. Oh, I wonder if I'll have one of those pug-nosed British dogs that licks its own snot all day. Ew, that's gross.
Piss off, you little wanker. I'm not gonna be a dog to some poof baby.
Well, lad, welcome to your home.
Well, this is more like it.
This is your valet, your gardener, your cook, your gamekeeper, your butler, your housekeeper, your parlourmaid, your housemaid, your scullery maid, your shoe degraveler, and one superfluous employee who I am not in a gay relationship with.
Sir, we have a meeting in the broom shed.
Quite right. I will now hand you over to your mother. This will be our last physical contact until I give you a firm handshake on your 18th birthday.
My God, this is everything I've ever wanted. And let's be honest, if I had stayed with the Griffins, I would have ended up like Rick Springfield today.
I wish that I had Jesse's job.
Sir, it's 6 p.m. and you're still in your 5:45 tuxedo.
Nigel, yesterday I saw you smile. Is that something I need to bring up with my father?
I was just imagining my own death, sir.
You're a good man, Nigel. May I pull on your nose hair?
Of course, sir.
Yeah!
My heavens, my father is the commander of the most excellent order of the British Empire, Dean of Physics at Oxford, and he was pre-approved for a Capital One no-hassle card. Oh, okay, so he's just framing everything.
Stuart, these are your brothers, Jaden and Aiden.
Jaden was first form in his sixth levels, and he's chief scrum flanker on his varsity boogling team, which as far as we know makes us terribly proud.
Finally siblings who are doing stuff. I'm really happy to meet you guys.
You were an accident. You're only here because father is a heavy sleeper with a frequent morning stem.
Okay, Aiden's the ball breaker, huh, Jaden?
Father, is it going to live here for a while?
Oh, Aiden is the nice one. Well, if it's verbal jousting skills you're looking for, I'm not afraid to take a little walk on the Oscar Wilde side. You are a poopy head, and you shut up.
Stuart, I think your mouth is better at taking things in than spewing them out.
Oh, these guys are a little sharper than my old family. I still remember our duck-duck-goose disaster.
Jack? 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 Jack.
What is that other word?
It's a long, long way to Tipperary, but my heart's right there.
Well done, boys.
Stuart, perhaps you'd like to regale us with song.
Okay, I would have liked a heads up so I could prepare something, but I'm sure I can whip something up. Wayne's World! Wayne's World! It's party time! It's excellent! What? What's wrong?
Stuart, I think your time might be better spent in the attic with your syphilitic one-eared cousin Earl.
Hey.
What's that? I can't hear you.
I was just saying hello.
Oh, there you are. Now you've got it. That's how we play.
There we are. Sorry I couldn't squeeze no more juice out of me nippers.
Oh, that's all right. I can't be mad at someone who lost 7 sons in the war.
All right, my little lord. It's time for bed.
Why isn't Mummy tucking me in?
Oh, hush, love. You're born now. That's the end of all this Mummy nonsense.
What the hell? I don't even get a stuffed animal to hug. The only thing in this crib is a 19th century dueling pistol. Ah! It's loaded?
Who dares to shoot the bow tie off my cat? We duel at dawn.
I'm just a baby.
So am I.
Good lord, what have I done? I don't like it here at all. I miss my family, my dumb family. Dear God, I wanted to be free of the family of morons I was born into, but now I'm the moron.
Sir, I heard whimpering. Shall I fetch your crying tuxedo?
No, I don't want any more tuxedos! And I don't want a cold mother or an Oxford physics professor father! Wait a minute. That's it! The Oxford physics lab will have everything I need to build a time machine! Then I can go back to my old life! Stone floor, too cold. I'll go in the morning. Let's see. I need plutonium for the time machine. How do I get past those guards? Oh, wait, that's right. I'm in England. I can just walk past them holding a cup of tea. Morning.
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 Did you see something suspicious about that baby?
Well, I did at first, but then he's got the tea vouching for him, doesn't he?
Almost there. Just a few more adjustments.
Stuart! What are you doing?
All right, Rupert. I left the fat man's entire porn collection on the curb for Goodwill to pick up.
No!
Who the devil are you? I'm British Stewie. I don't hear anything different. I sound the same, but I spell some words very differently. Let me write the word colour on a piece of paper for you. Dear God, you are British! Listen to me. You successfully prevented your own birth, and instead you were born into an alternate family. But you must believe me. The Griffins are your true destiny. No, they're not. They're morons. But they're your morons, and they care about you. Besides, you shine among these dullards, like Bob Weir in The Grateful Dead. That joke's for one of our crew guys, Maddie. He loves the dead, and he's not doing so well. We love you, Captain Trips. Hang in, bro. Well, I do like being better than everyone else.
Peter, I had nothing to do with donating your stupid pawn.
If what you're telling me is true, we can't let them separate. If Peter leaves, I'll be unborn. Well, she's not going to stop him. She's furious. You're right. And if I know her, she'll be heading to the fridge for her angry afternoon Chardonnay. I've got an idea.
Okay, there it is. Noon.
Oh, no! He's leaving! I'm fading away!
Peter, wait!
What, you want to yell at me some more?
No, I want to tell you I'm sorry. I don't want you to leave.
Why should I stay if you don't even trust me?
I do trust you, Peter. I don't know what's gotten into us lately. The important thing is we're meant to be together. I love you, Peter.
Oh, I love you too, Lois. I'm glad we're staying together. Honestly, I don't know what I would do on my own. Like, I literally have no idea where food comes from. Is it that guy? Is he the food man?
No, Peter, it's not him.
They're making up! It's working! That means soon you will not exist. Then, I guess this is goodbye, Stewie. I'll miss you. You've taught me so much, and you've been a good friend, and you as well. Ah! Damn it! Help me, Stewie! Lift it off! Ugh, that looks really heavy. It is, and it's incredibly painful! Please help! You know, you'll be fading away any moment. You know, it'll be a lot of effort, ultimately, for nothing. I'm choking on my own blood! Call someone, please! Well, again, it was great knowing you. Yeah, you bastard! You'll burn in hell! Ugh, finally. That was an ordeal. I did it! I'm back! Oh, damn it, I left my chapstick in the past.
Chapstick! With smooth lips, I will finally be able to be a mayor who kisses babies with confidence.
Hey, cracked lips!
You'll see! You'll all see!